So if there are any question on this, I'll respond to it. Tomorrow I'll try to sum up other four steps. Yes.
Hello.
Yes.
Namaskar ji.
Namaste.
Sir, from last 1 week, I am not getting the link. Actually, I am not having any question regarding this, but I am not having, not getting the link for the this meeting.
Okay, Bihari Nandan ji will respond to it.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Bihari ji, bataiye.
Sir, link is directly goes to every participant. Maybe some problem is there from maybe sir's side, because if he's registered, then definitely the link will be goes automatically every day.
Last even link I got on 16th, sir, 16th October.
I will check your ID, sir.
Yes, sir, please. Vijaypal@rediffmail.com.
Yes, Vijaypal. Sir. One another thing, sir. If you are not getting any link for the coming day, then you have to join with the previous link.
I am usually doing the same thing. But I thought that you are keep it sending. You are sending it these days or not? I just ask because of that.
Yes, sir. It will automatically goes to everyone. But if any problem is there, I will check it out. Then I will short out this button.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Namaste, Ganesh ji.
Namaste, namaste.
I am very happy to hear you. I have attended your workshop in 2014, Triple IT.
Very nice.
I have been practicing. What my doubt is, if I want to pay attention in myself, then only I can pay attention. If I am unable to attention in within myself, I can see only after coming into the action. So many times without awareness, the actions are going on because it comes into action. So after action only, sometimes it may be correct or sometimes it may be wrong. Because of without awareness of what is going on in the self. So is there any practices helping us to put more attention on the self? What is going on in the self? For continuous observation of the self. So I have realized the most important step is I have to put attention on the self. But I'm unable to pay attention on the self every moment. So is there any practice helping me to put attention on every moment in myself? This is my...
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah. See, there are a few things which we must take note of. First, number one is that we have the capacity to pay attention. We mean self. Self has the capacity to pay attention. This is number one. Number two, the self is paying attention to whatever it considers important. This also we have been able to see, you know, when we are working through this exercise one. We looked into this aspect that we are paying attention to things which we consider are important. Number three, till now we thought that self is not important. And therefore we were not paying attention to the self.
Okay.
Right. Now that we are able to see that self is important, we will start paying attention to the self. So this is a very simple phenomenon that is going to take place.
Okay, sir, okay.
Now, fourth observation is that at this moment, if there are two things which I consider important, which I will pay attention to? The answer is very simple. Whichever I consider to be more important, I pay attention to that on a priority basis. Right. So I think, you know, preparing for the class is important. So I'm paying attention to preparing for the class. But if there is an alarm, okay, in the house regarding the cooker or, you know, something, then you immediately pay attention to that.
Yes, sir. Yes.
The whistle from the cooker, you think that it is more important to pay attention to the cooker. So you start paying attention to the cooker, right? So this is a very natural phenomenon. So if I can see that self is the most important thing, then my attention will start going to the self on a priority basis. So first, I will pay attention to the self, make sure that there is a right feeling there, there is a right thought there. With that, I am in a state of harmony and happiness. Right? And once I have ensured this, then I will start paying attention to other things. I will start paying attention to the body. I will start paying attention to the clothes, you know, to things around in the house. Right, my lecture in the, you know, college, all those will come later. So on a priority basis, I will fix my feeling, my thought, because that seems to be the most important, right? Because my basic desire is for continuity of happiness and prosperity. And to ensure this continuity of happiness, I have to make sure that my feeling is, you know, the feeling which is natural and not otherwise. So my feeling, I can see that is most important. So I will pay attention to my feeling. I will set that feeling right, you know, my thought right. And then I will, you know, pay attention to things around. Today, what is happening? It is the other way. We think that things outside are more important. Therefore, we are paying attention to things outside on a priority basis. And we feel that this self is okay, you know, I have to pay attention, but there are other important things. So I must pay attention to other things which are more important. And then I can come back and start paying attention to the self. So that is the issue. So what should we do? We have to realize that self is the most important thing, as you said, right? The feeling in the self is most important. I must pay attention to it. I must it, and I'm in a state of harmony and happiness. Then I have all the time to look around, pay attention to everything around, starting from body to physical facility to other human beings and all that. So we don't have to do anything special for it. We just have to understand that self is important. This imagination in the self is important. This feeling in the self is important. Right? If I can see this, my attention will keep going to my feeling first. Yes.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Exactly what you said that is happening.
Yes.
Thank you.
True. Before we started with exercise, one hardly we were, you know, paying attention to the feeling in the self. Now at least, you know, 100 times more we are paying attention.
Really, it is helping us. This UHV is helping us in many dimensions, and the transformation has been taking place in most of the people. I'm very thankful to you.
Yes. We are all thankful to this coexistence, this harmony, this relationship. Okay, can we ask Geeta ji to this?
Namaste ji.
Yes, Geeta ji, namaste.
Happy to see you back. Happy to hear your voice, ji.
Yes, yes. In a while, we'll keep sharing.
Ji, right from the day, I'm attending the morning session. My family members, particularly my spouse, is against always attending this morning session. But so I was having a feeling of opposition. Now, slowly I'm developing a feeling of relationship. So I'm feeling the comfort inside. I'm feeling happy. So previously, since there was opposition right from the morning, I was struggling for all these days. But slowly I have started. And I started feeling that the feeling of relationship gives me happiness inside me. So that is the one I just wanted to share with you all.
Yes. Yes. True. You know, this is interesting to see that things are not changing outside. But just by the change inside, my state of happiness is changing. So very interesting thing to observe.
Ji, also I want to add. So just now, my spouse came in and he was making some loud noise.
Yes.
Because he doesn't like.
Mm.
So at times I'm sleeping, Ji, because. Yes. I'm having the feeling of opposition, but slowly I have come to the realization on my part that it is me who is deciding the feeling.
Yes.
So now I'm having the right understanding, Ji.
Yes.
That slowly my family members, will see the behavior change in me. That I'm undergoing a process. So if I have that right understanding, and because of that, if I develop the feeling of relationship, see, I'm able to feel that innate happiness. But many times I'm slipping, G.
Yes, yes. But
I'm having those glimpses. So that gives the assurance to me. Yes. Work on yourself, Geeta. Definitely. Things will be all right. So that assurance I'm getting, Ji, because this is a reality. This is a ground truth. If I work on myself, if I work particularly on my feeling part.
True.
So I'm in the process, Ji, and I'm happy that I could feel it.
Yeah.
That the feeling of relationship definitely will make happiness or comfort inside us, that is for sure. If I'm unable to retain that feeling of relationship, then I have to work on that. So that part, that conviction I'm getting, G, these days, slowly I'm getting that assurance, G. So that I just wanted to share with you all happily, G. Thank you so much, G.
True. It will take time, certainly, because we have a whole lot of preconditionings, you know, that we have accumulated about ourselves, about our body, about the world around. So our attention will keep going to things which we considered important and which we still consider important or more important than the self. So all that will certainly happen and it will take time. But The important thing is that, as you said, you know, we are able to get the glimpse of the fact that I am the master of my feeling and therefore my happiness. So this glimpse itself is a very big, you know, thing, you know, it opens up a very vast possibility, okay, that I am the master, I am the one who is, you know, who has the capacity to ensure the right feeling within myself by choice. And with this right feeling, I can ensure happiness within me, harmony within me, irregardless of the conditions outside. So this gives us a complete sense of swatantrata, you know, complete sense of liberation, freedom from the world outside. So we thought that we are unhappy because of unfavorable condition in the world outside. Now we can see that this is not true. We are unhappy because we have not made the right choice about our own feeling. So the world outside may be going wrong, but this world outside is not responsible, solely responsible for my unhappiness. So with whatever condition is there around me, I can still take a decision in favor of having a right feeling, a feeling which is natural to me. And with that feeling, I can be in a state of harmony and happiness within. Not only that, I am not dependent on the world outside for my feeling and my happiness. But if I can see this, that I am the master of my feeling and I can take the right decision on my feeling, then with that right feeling, I will be in a state of harmony and happiness within. And with that feeling, and that state of happiness, I can respond to the world outside rather than react to it. And when I'm responding to the world outside, I'm able to help the world outside improve. That is a natural consequence. That is a natural consequence. So this is very interesting. That I am in a state of swatantrata, I am self-organized, I am not dictated by the world outside. Right? I am not, you know, kind of under the control of the world outside. I can decide for my own feeling and my state of happiness. And with that feeling and the state of happiness within, I can be responsible to the world outside. So rather than reacting to the world outside, I can respond to the world outside by ensuring the right feeling in myself, by ensuring a state of happiness within. So this is what is swatantrata. This is what is liberation. Right. So we have to realize this and be with, you know, a state of right feeling within, a state of harmony and happiness within, and with that respond to the world outside. So I'm liberated from the, you know, enforcement of the world outside, which I thought, you know, I thought that this world is forcing me to a state of unhappiness. But now I can liberate myself from this. I can identify what is my right feeling, what is my natural feeling. I can have those feelings in me and I can be in a state of harmony and happiness. And with that, not only that we don't react to the world outside, but we respond to the world outside. And which will help the world outside improve. Can you see that, Geeta ji?
Yes, ji. That gives me the assurance, that gives me the confidence, ji. Yes. That is why still I am continuing the morning sessions, ji. I know there is an opposition. They are not able to accept the fact, right, sitting before the laptop right from the morning.
Yeah.
They are thinking something unusual, something not good for a woman to sit before a laptop. So that is the feeling they are having, ji. So, but now I am able to understand. Yes. With that right understanding, I am just putting my steps.
Yeah, slowly they will, you know, when they find the change in your behavior. They will, you know, be able to see that, you know, this is something which is making a right, you know, kind of change in you. And then they will be able to appreciate. And after some time, they will even start facilitating you, you know, that morning time will keep you free, you know, because this is something which is working on you. So it is not that they have a feeling, you know, a feeling of opposition for you. Fact is that they are not able to understand what you are doing. So, of our, you know, this kind of lack of kind of clarity as to, you know, what you are doing and why you are doing. So it is not the feeling of opposition. But they are not able to see why you are doing this. And once they are able to see that, yes, this is something which is making a significant change in you, they will start appreciating it and they will start facilitating it.
And the important part, G, when I am, when my spouse sees that I am conversing, then he makes some sound noise at the back, G. Today also he made some loud noise by hitting the latch and all.
Yeah, so they have concern for you. So they are, you know, feeling related and they have concern. So they are also testing your nerves. This feeling that you have related in you, okay, is it stable or unstable? Yes, so they are taking your test.
And definitely, I will come out of this experiment successfully.
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Ji. Thanks a lot for the entire UHVT, for this eye-opener session and for this realization, Ji. Thanks a lot. That's it from my side, Ji.
We have Nair, Deepa Nair Ji. So I can take her question and then I will switch over to the Hindi session. So we can continue these questions in Hindi. But okay, let's take the question from Deepa Nayarji first. Question or any sharing. Yes, Deepa ji, you can speak out. You can, your mic is already unmuted, but there is.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, you are audible now.
This is also somewhat similar to the same observation as Geeta ji was saying. Earlier also, when I was able to observe my feeling, most of the time I was thinking that I am happy. As you said today, is this an innate feeling. I was thinking that in my innate nature, I was having a feeling of being happy almost most of the time. But sometimes some certain situations we may feel that or we are feeling unhappy. So I was able to notice that it is not the outside situation. It is myself itself that making me uncomfortable. And I am having the potential to change myself to make me happy. But in certain situations, yeah, that was what Geeta Ji was also saying. When our relationships, if they have some issue with us, so we may be getting unhappy and we may be having that disharmony. And if you are able to think that through right understanding, I can see that, so I have to be happy. But sometimes, yeah, yesterday also the same thing happened. Most of the time, if we are busy in our things, we are not able to get look after their things, like my spouse and my son. And they are saying that all the time you are busy and you are not looking after us. You have to prioritize the things. You need to see this also most of the time. Because of this pandemic situation, we are working in a hybrid mode. So we have to we have to sit online and need to go to university. So many duties are there. So when they are saying this and we are thinking that, I have this capacity, I can become happy and I can be in harmony in myself and my husband or my son, they may be thinking that, they are saying that, okay, after this conversation, after some time, they also go back to harmony. But I can see that disharmony in them. So that means I'm not able to pay that much attention to them means. So I don't know how to improve this in the sense if I am prioritizing the things and I'm giving more time to them, that case, there can be a situation that can develop disharmony in me. Like that Geeta ma'am was saying, she's sitting in front of the computer. The same type of situations in most of our houses also, even not for the ladies, for the men also. So, and we are thinking that some of the things we need to prioritize and we have to do this and that. But there also, if they are able to see the change in your behavior means that also, I don't know how far I am able to see make such a very big difference. Actually, there is no big disharmony there, but I don't know how to handle this. It's not a very big issue, but still, there is an issue that actually not with me. I am able to understand this with that right understanding. I can develop that harmony in me. But with the other person, they are having that disharmony at least for some moment. And later, they may getting back to harmony. But actually, we all need happiness in continuity. So how will we be able to achieve this for us and for them? And improving their completeness and those.
Yeah, so the.
Far we are successful in that.
There are two questions. One is, how can we ensure continuity for ourselves? Second is, how we can ensure this continuity for others?
Yes, maybe the second question is more because within myself, I'm okay. I can see that not that. Very big issue, but with the other person, I'm more concerned. Even if I'm saying that he or she will understand the change in me, they will be able to see the difference in my character. They are saying that there are many changes in you. We can see that, but still there is a disharmony in them that I can observe.
Yeah. So. Good thing is that at least we have answer to the first question, right?
Yes, yes.
We have answer to the question as to how we can ensure continuity of happiness for ourselves.
Yes.
So this is a very good news, you know.
Yes.
Big thing.
Yes.
So that I can be my own master, right?
Yes, most of the time, because I was feeling it as an innate nature in me, but a little bit small issues were making me unhappy. But that also I'm able to manage now. That means I can see that right understanding in myself. That I see is that I can see as a very big achievement. Yes, definitely it's there.
Yes. Now, if I can see this first one, I can see that the same will apply for the other.
So
the path that I have taken will be applicable to the other also. The problem with the other is that he is still with the expectation that other will make him happy or her happy. And that is not going to happen. So as we saw, nobody can really make me happy in continuity. I have to develop this right understanding, this right feeling, right thought in me to ensure continuity of happiness. So at least I have the answer for myself, and I can also see that this is the ultimate answer for the other. In the meantime, what do we do? That is the question, right?
Yes, yes. Improving their competence or to improve my own competence, that also is required.
Yes, yes. Now, in the meantime, there is one choice, that I keep my feeling intact and therefore the state of happiness intact. And with that, I am trying to respond to the other. The other choice is that I get disturbed myself. Right? I have an unnatural feeling in me. I become unhappy and I react. So which is the right choice?
Yes, I have to keep my feeling intact and then I need to work for them to improve their competence. That can be better, I think.
Yes. So once I make this choice that I am keeping my feeling in place, okay, and then I am trying to respond to the other, then one thing is that I will not react. I will not become unhappy myself and I will not react. The problem with us is that we are disturbing our own feeling. And with that disturbed feeling, we start reacting. So let us handle that, you know. So ensure this right feeling, ensure this, you know, right thought in you. And with that, you will be able to respond. And when you are responding, you will be able to see, given my own condition, given the condition of the other, right, what can be the possible solution at this moment of time. So that we have to work out. That we have to work out every moment in every situation, right?
Yes.
Yes. So that is something we'll start working, you know. It will take time. It will take time. So I will try to do whatever I can do to facilitate the others at this moment.
Yes, yes. That's right. What I also always think. Whatever I can do, they are saying this complaint. So I have to see that also, because my natural acceptance is to make them happy, to improve our relationship. So let them, I should not disturb their harmony. That way also, I think, yes.
True.
So I need to work on that.
Yes, but I can start doing something, you know, as a response right now. But there is no guarantee that this other person will become happy, because, you know, ultimately his happiness will depend upon his state of his self, you know, his feeling, his thought. So if he has generated some unnatural feeling in him or her, you know, the other person will be unhappy.
Yes.
It's kind of how well I am responding to it. So I will not get disturbed by that. I will continue to respond. And one of the response would be that in the long term, I will try to ensure this, you know, help him to ensure this right understanding and right feeling in himself. Right. So there I have to work. Till then, all this will happen.
Yes.
Till the other person has this right understanding and right feeling in him or her, this will keep happening. The other person will feel dissatisfied, you know, unhappy. So I have to ensure this solution for myself, and then I have to respond to the other. And this responding will be a process, you know, which will go on for a long time till this other person has this right understanding and right feeling in himself. Then he will become a source of response and not reaction. He will be in a state of harmony and happiness and be a source of, you know, response for others. Till then, there will be reactions coming from the other. But by that reaction, I should not get disturbed, you know, in this self and start reacting.
Yes, yes.
Yes.
But there also sometimes we can see that even though we are thinking that we have to respond, not to react, but sometimes we do. Yeah,
that is our problem. That we have
yes,
to
that's about. Our problem. There also we need to work on that.
Yes.
Yes. Thank you, Ganeshji. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Okay. Namaste. Dhanyavaad.
Namaste, Bhaiya. Namaste, Ji. Sabhi ko namaste.
Namaste. Namaste.
Ji, after discussing with you, I had a small thought crossing my mind. Whether we can say that Mahatma Gandhi fight against the British, but he was having the feeling of relationship. Similarly, I also need not surrender when people are against me or some unethical practices happens. If someone dominates me, I need to surrender to them. So I can also fight, but I have to fight with the feeling of relationship. Am I correct, Jaji, in drawing some conclusions like this?
Because yeah, in fact, what Gandhiji himself said was that at the base of the movement that he's carrying out, is ahimsa. Ahimsa essentially means that I do not have any feeling of opposition towards the other. Yes. What is being said is that, you know, in a sense, what it would mean that I have a feeling of relationship towards the other. So this feeling of relationship, the feeling of love, is what is fundamental, what is, you know, desirable. At least I should not have the feeling of opposition. So the difference between prem and ahimsa is that when one is saying prem, meaning of relationship. When one is saying ahimsa, it is at least not having a feeling of opposition. So he called his movement as non-violent movement. Ahimsatmak Andolan. So whenever I am, you know, kind of raising a voice against injustice, I should not have this feeling of opposition towards the other. A minimum required. It will certainly be better if I have the feeling of love for the other. Right. So that is what he said about his movement. And the unfortunate thing is that, you know, if you don't understand these things from within, then outside we may call it by the same name. But we end up having feeling of opposition. And that is the reason you see so much of degeneration of this non-violent movement, you know, in the whole country today. So I have to have this, you know, at the base of this non-violent movement, I have to have this feeling of love. And at the base of this feeling of love, I have to have this understanding of relationship, harmony, and coexistence. So once I have this understanding of relationship, harmony, and coexistence, I have this feeling of love and compassion, then I can really work for the social justice. So number one, I will try to ensure this justice myself. And number two, I will try to make sure that, you know, we in due course of time develop a system which ensures justice. And at least, you know, we must ensure a system which, you know, avoids any injustice. Or if there is an injustice going on, we must, you know, make effort to stop it. But that is stopping this injustice, or movement for stopping the injustice, is with the feeling of love and compassion. So that is what is expected. Whether we are able to do it or not, that is the expectation, and that is what he said about his movement, about his non-violent movement. So he would say these three things, Satya, Prema, and Karuna. Knowing the truth, having this feeling of love, and expressing in terms of compassion. And therefore, this inner development is very significant thing in that kind of movement. If the inner development is not there, I'm not able to ensure this knowledge and this feeling of love in myself, then if I'm working in the world outside to ensure justice, there is a great chance that I end up having a feeling of opposition. And if I have a feeling of opposition, I am likely to damage the other. Yes.
Guruji, yesterday after having a discussion with you, I was contemplating with what was discussed, and I am sure I was able to get whatever you have said, G. When I am fighting inside with a feeling of opposition, particularly towards my spouse, there is nothing no use in teaching my students, in taking UHV, and I was able to relate with Mahatma Gandhiji. So I thought that I have to surrender before to avoid all this. I thought I have to surrender. Then I came across the thought of Mahatma Gandhiji, who fought against the British, but he fought with the feeling of relationship. So I also must have that. And if I don't have that inner change, there is no use in teaching to my students or in sharing with others. So that and all, I was able to get it and feel it yesterday, G. And I thought if nobody raised the hand today morning, so I should first clear this doubt. Yes, I was having that same thought, whatever you have shared, G. If I am going to fight against injustice, fight against something wrong, definitely I must have the feeling of relationship. Thank you so much, Ji. I was able to get that feel yesterday itself after discussing with you. Thanks a lot, Ji. Thank you so much.
Yeah, there are two parts in what you are saying. Part one is that, well, I'm fighting against injustice. I must have this feeling of affection, feeling of relationship in myself. The second part is that when I'm working for it, and I have not ensured this feeling of relationship, and I am working on it, do I share with others? My response would be that I would certainly share with others if I have something, you know, a right proposal with me. But I will share it with the other as a co-explorer. And not as a teacher. So that is the difference.
Okay, Ji.
It's not that I will not share it with the other until I have, you know, ensured this within myself every moment. No, when I'm working on it, I will share it with others as a point. And that I think is important.
Okay, Ji.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Gita Ji. Thank you very much.
Lots of gratitude, pranams and prayers, Ji. Thanks a lot. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Okay, we have Tara Prashna.
Yes. Sir, namaste. Namaste, Sabiko. Sir, this referring to Gita Didi's query, that I was also facing similar situation 1 month or 2 months back. You know, my wife is also a working lady. So many times it happens, you know, anything comes and we used to, you know, though we don't fight or, you know, there is something becomes discomfort and which leads to, you know, loss of harmony or makes us sad. So when I started doing this exercise, so in that process, when I started observing the feeling, then at that moment of, you know, when I started discomfort, that means there is somewhere the feeling of opposition started. Then in that process, when I realized that, you know, I should not have feeling of opposition at the natural acceptance level. So she is no one else. So she was related to me. So she is, means I started the feeling of being related to in that way. So when it realized within, so the very next times, the same words came or same kind of situation came, but it certainly did not create any, you know, disturbance within. That is one of the greatest realization when I discovered within myself. So when the words like, you know, injustice or, you know, like something wrong she was saying, so in that way, it was somewhere we need to look back that, yes, is it I am talking out of, you know, being related to or feeling an opposition. We may say anything, but at the back of the mind, what we are thinking, we means I only can observe. So that is one of the very finest observation, or I can say finest change within me I have observed, not only for wife, but for many occasions. And still, there is further extension to this discussion. She was initially, she has taken both the course, UHV, the first one, then UHV one also. But she was not so explorative in that sense. Means, I am giving time here and many activities I am taking, but some time I may not give much time in the family. So she was a little bit, you know, not in that sense very happy that I was spending so much time. Suddenly, one day, I used to discuss that whatever we are exploring here, in many occasions in the family with my kid or with my father or even with her, I used to put proposals. Like, and in many occasions, proposals are not being, you know, either it is not being heard properly or it is not, it is being discussed a bit, or it may be listened only but not discussed. But in that process, when after the end of the around this one month or so, one day it is to my surprise, there is similar kind of situation where there may be a fight, there could be a fight, but it is again I will say another, you know, a very beautiful experience that it when I did not react, one statement came like, though I am saying many things, but we are not fighting like earlier. Then that feeling she had that I'm not reacting. Then suddenly we started discussing, and few proposals I made in that way we normally put proposals in the program, like what you are thinking inside, or you try to check your own feeling. So at that moment, she started feeling, oh yeah, right. So in this way, like though there may be some feeling of opposition in her or something like that, but still she is realizing a little bit the the power of natural acceptance or the power of self, I would say. And in that process, I think it is definitely time taking, but once we make our thought process, you know, lined with natural acceptance, so the path will be much easier, and what we say, the continuity of happiness can be certain. And in addition to the example Geeta Didi gave, that like referring to Mahatma Gandhi or whatever, that's a good example for inspiration, inspire or to guide self. But again, at the same time, we are referring to the outside. This is something, you know, we can, you are referring to outside, it will give you a temporary feelings. Means it will be temporary. But when you are referring to self with all these, nine feelings we have gone through, I think it will be a permanent thing. So that's what, sir, I want to give my reflection. And just to another thing, sir, out of, you know, this social justice we were discussing. Sir, I sometimes believe that, we are talking about government and rest of the elected candidate at opposition, or we call it opposition. So instead of it, if, you know, I think someday it may be possible that when the situation, like we all are at least having right understanding and right feeling, and at the level of this administration, this government, and I must say, like, it will be a government associate, in that way the opposition may be renamed. So in that day, I think, you know, like the people are fighting, everything, anything government is saying, opposition has to oppose. So that kind of spirit will go. Rather, whatever government is saying, with right understanding, people will come back that, you know, that can be associated with this, so it can be improved in that way. So these are few reflections, sir, I want to give. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, this is very important, you know. This is a very important discovery of the law of consciousness. So what we are studying today in the name of science is the law of material. But now we can slowly see that there are certain definite laws of consciousness which we can understand, and those will become the guide for our living, you know, for our life. So this is one such law that, you know, you discovered within yourself, that even in our day-to-day transactions, you know, with our own very near and dear, we don't have this clarity about the feeling that we have, you know, and we end up having feeling of opposition on a small, you know, reaction from the other. On the other hand, if I can, you know, see the relationship, understand the relationship, and have this feeling of relationship with the other, then the small reactions or small mistakes on the part of the other would not generate this feeling of opposition. It will rather, you know, generate that kind of response in me, whereby I will try to improve, you know, help the other improve upon himself or herself. And if I do that, that's the real way of going about ensuring justice, you know, first for myself and then for others.
Very true, sir. Very true.
Yes. So this is what we are trying to do. In fact, we are trying to give proposals about this world of coexistence, harmony, and relationship. Okay. This world of material, this world of consciousness, you know, and therefore, you know, giving proposals about the laws of material as well as the laws of consciousness. And once we understand them and we can discover them for ourselves through this process of self-exploration, then it becomes a part of our being. And then it makes all the difference in our life, makes all the difference in our life. So that is what we are trying to do.
Sir, another difficulty in the self-exploration I want to discuss, sir. Sir, when something is happening outside... Yes, sir. Please.
Yeah. So this was part one of what you said. In part two, this issue of these parties, you know, political parties. This is a very important issue. In fact, there was a workshop for all the parliament members in Bhutan. And after this 3 days workshop for all of them, this was one interesting observation that came in from the people who were in the, you know, other side of the government. And they said that, I mean, they have more or less adopted the Indian kind of electorate form. So with some modification, of course. So they said that till now we were calling ourselves as opposition party. Now we will call ourselves as complementary party, you know, party, and not opposition party. So this is what is expected, that, you know, these two parties or N parties in the government are supposed to be complementary parties. If this government is not able to see, or the party in the government is not able to see something for the good of the people, then it is the role of these other parties to ensure, you know, that, you know, they bring this in their notice. and they become complementary to the government, not the opposition. But that's how we have perceived this thing today, no? That
yes.
The very name, opposition party, it gives you this feeling that you have to have this feeling of opposition with the other, which is not desirable.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So we'll slowly discover all these laws of consciousness, laws of relationship, laws of, you know, how the self is able to ensure harmony and happiness within. So all those we are trying to discover. Yes.
Yeah, sir. When anything is happening around me and I am taking it to the observation that what kind of feeling is going on me, and in most of the time I am able to get, yes, this is something naturally acceptable. So, yeah, this is going on. But in many occasions, I cannot refer in certain circumstance like social injustice kind of thing. When I refer to within myself, so it is taking time to refer to the natural acceptance level. And even sometimes I am not getting the answer within. So do you have anything other than being related to or feeling of opposition? Any other kind of feeling can we feel? Means in accordance to all the trust, love and others, respect, gratitude. So all these are there. But the major feelings are either being related to or feeling of opposition. So anything else, sir, is there that which give us something, some kind of feeling where we cannot make a decision quickly, or we cannot get the response from the natural acceptance quickly?
See, you don't get the response from the natural acceptance if you are trying to see things at the level of action or even at the level of thought. So what we need to do is to go to the level of feeling. And at the level of feeling, we will be able to decide what is naturally acceptable and what is not naturally acceptable. That is important. For example, if you ask me whether I should eat rice or I should eat wheat or, maize. Okay, what is right? This cannot be decided by the natural acceptance. But if you ask me, what is my natural acceptance towards my body, to nurture the body or to harm the body? So this towards the body, I can verify through my natural acceptance and say that my feeling is to nurture the body. That is what is naturally acceptable to me. Okay. Now, with that feeling of nurturing the body, now I will work out the details of how to nurture the body. So, if I am in Odisha and rice is grown in Odisha because there is a suitable climate there for rice, then I will eat rice to nurture my body. If I am in Maharashtra, then probably I will eat, maize or jowar, because that is what is grown easily, with that, whatever conditions are there in the nature around. So this, whether to eat wheat or rice, cannot be decided on the basis of natural acceptance. Because this is a matter of thought. How to fulfill that feeling of nurturing the body. Okay. But I can certainly decide whether I have to have this feeling of nurturing the body or harming the body. Okay. And that is very important. So when I'm eating food, I can ask myself, whether I'm eating it for nurturing the body or I'm eating it just for the taste, even at the cost of harming the body. So that's a very important question to ask. So today, for example, the way, you know, this food industry is going and the way people are getting, you know, addicted to that kind of food, junk food, what we call, we are eating those food because they, you know, seem to be tasty. And we are eating them even if they are harmful for the body. So the main issue is this, whether we are having the feeling of nurturing the body or harming the body. That we can decide on the basis of natural effects. But when it comes to thought, comes to detailing of how to fulfill that feeling, you know, comes to action outside in response to those feelings, there the details will depend upon your feeling, number one. Number two, the whole condition around, you know, your own condition, the condition of the nature around, the condition of the other person with whom you are interacting, right? So if you ask me whether it is right to, you know, talk in English or in Hindi, right, this cannot be decided on the basis of natural acceptance. If you know English, I know English, you know, I can talk in English. But if you don't know English and you know Hindi, and I also know Hindi, right, though I know English also, okay, I'll talk in Hindi. So this, whether talking in Hindi or English is right or wrong, cannot be decided through your natural acceptance. Okay. But whether I'm talking to you, shall I talk with the feeling of relationship or feeling of opposition? This I can decide through my natural acceptance. That is why, if you remember, we started with observing this, you know, imagination.
Yes.
And then we talked about the feeling, the thought that we have. And then we have been focusing on feeling. In step two, step three, we are focusing on the feeling, not on the imagination as a whole, or the thought, for example, or action.
Yes. Yes. So thank you. That real thing I now can realize that yes, we are in the imagination and we are thinking about action. So very rightly said, sir. I could not able to see that.
Yes.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you very much. We have few more hands raised, so I'll just
good morning, sir.
Kind of respond to one or two of them, and then I'll like to sum up these other four steps. So, okay.
Good morning. Can you hear my voice, sir?
Yes.
I am Dr. Arunachalam. My imagination is going. For example, I am going to the bus. So 50 passengers seats are there. So all the passengers are sitting. Two passengers are standing. You can imagine. Then one passenger move outside, one seat is empty. Two passengers are standing. I am near to that the seat, I want to sit. This is human rights. If my wife is there, I wanted to give the seat to my wife. If others are there, I don't, in my mindset, I only sit. My body needs the comfort. Here is it, selfies are sacred. What is your answer?
No, my answer would be that I have the relationship for everyone around. And depending upon the need of this other, I will, you know, give the seat to the other. Okay. That is what is natural to do. And you can see, I mean, most of the problem that we are creating today around us is because that we are not able to see with this perception. And we end up giving higher priority to those whom we feel related. And this we do even at the cost of those who are not, whom we don't feel related to. Okay. So it is true that my basic responsibility is there towards my family members. Oh. I have to nurture them, I have to take care of them, right? But I must be clear that this is not to be done at the cost of others. So this clarity has to be there. The problem is not that I am giving preference to my family members. The problem comes when I start giving preference to my family members at the cost of other people. Corruption, for example, you know, what is this corruption? Corruption is basically, I am trying to exploit the people whom I don't feel related to for the people whom I feel related to. Can you see this?
Yes.
Yes. That is the problem. The problem is not that I am taking care of my family and I am nurturing the family, I am educating them and all that. There is no problem in that. That's my prime responsibility and I am doing it.
But that is human rights.
My problem is also, my responsibility is also to take care of the, you know, other people, at least at the level of feeling. I must have this feeling of relationship for everyone around. In that case, at least I will not harm them. But non-violent that we were talking about in the beginning, right?
Yes.
I will not be violent towards others. That is important. That is the minimum. This social injustice is coming because not only that I am limiting myself to take care of my family members, but I am willing to harm the other. Right?
For in case of old people are there, I give the seat. In case of old people or some handicapped are there, my mind goes to there. But both are in the similar age, I am able to give the, I give the preference to me. That is my rights. Is it correct, sir?
This is my responsibility, not the issue of right. The issue of, I mean, this is my responsibility to take care of my family members, right? To have this feeling of relationship for them and therefore take care of them. But does it mean therefore that I can do it at the cost of others? Or I do it for my family members as my basic responsibility, and I am also willing to do it for the other. So at least I am not doing this for my family members at the cost of the other. That is the issue. And if I can see this, it will not lead to social injustice. Today, all this corruption, what is it? Can you see that? You are willing to exploit those whom you don't feel related to at the cost of, for the purpose of doing something extra for your family members, what you call as family members. That is creating problem. Number one. Number two, see all these examples where we start with the crisis. Okay. Now, you are not there in the bus all the time and, you know, traveling and there is a scarcity of seat. Most of the time you are at home. Okay. So, and in your village or in your town or in your colony, there are you able to ensure justice for your family and for others? Or at least, are you making sure that you are not doing injustice to others? Okay, for getting some extra benefit for your family members. I would say that is important.
Yes, thank you. We can care for the, about our society without any corruption. That is our content I want.
Very simple thing, you know.
Yeah.
And I'm not doing anything extra by doing that. So I'm not even fighting for justice. I'm just ensuring justice.
Yes.
I mean, all these words for justice. This fighting itself is injustice.
Fighting for rights is correct.
This is what I'm saying. Now, what is that right?
The rules and regulations are there, already created the laws.
Okay, reflect over it. Reflective over it. This man-made laws, they have to be in harmony with the, you know, laws of the nature. The laws of material, laws of consciousness. We can't make laws which are not in harmony with the natural laws.
Yes.
Yes. We have to think all these things.
Okay. Right. Thank you, sir.
We are purposely not raising up all these issues immediately, but you know, first we are trying to understand these basic laws of nature, you know, which includes the laws of material world and the laws of world of consciousness. And if you look at exercise one, very interestingly, we are trying to investigate into the world, the laws of world of consciousness. So one basic law we have understood is that when I want to observe myself, I can observe myself. Right? I have the capacity to observe. I have the capacity to pay attention and observe. I can observe things outside. I can observe things out inside. This is one very interesting law, right? That we made in the step one. And now after 1 month of exercise, each one of us is able to see this law, right? By our own direct observation. That whenever I decide to pay attention to something, I can pay attention to it, whether it is outside or inside. And when I pay attention, I can see. When I see, I can understand. This is one law of consciousness. Okay. And now we are able to see this law, right? Verify it ourselves. The second law is that there are some feelings in the self which are natural. There are some feelings which are unnatural. Some are naturally acceptable, some are not naturally acceptable. This is the second law of consciousness. The third law of consciousness is that if I have a feeling which is natural, which is naturally acceptable to me, it leads to a state of harmony and happiness. This is the third law, right? So each step we are trying to investigate into one law or the other, right? Then the fourth step, we said, whenever there is a feeling in me, whether natural or unnatural, it is me who is deciding it. It is not decided by the circumstances outside or the person outside. It is ultimately decided by me. So I am the owner of that feeling that I have at this moment. And therefore, if there is a feeling which is not naturally acceptable to me and it is giving rise to disharmony and unhappiness, I am responsible for it. Similarly, if there is a feeling which is natural to me, right, and this is giving rise to harmony and happiness, I am responsible for it. And therefore, I am responsible for my happiness as well as unhappiness. And if I can see it, observe it every moment, I can say with confidence that I am 100% responsible for my happiness and unhappiness. This is the fourth law of consciousness. Can you see this and appreciate?
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
And once we understand these laws, we can very well be with these laws, right? And that makes all the difference in my life. My life and in the life of people around me. So what Tara Prashna was telling, okay, it makes difference in the life of people around me as well. First, it makes a difference in my life, and then it makes a difference in the life of people around. Good. So with this, there are another two hands raised, but I'll take them in the Hindi session. We have Anil Alawat, and then we have Sopan Chananaji, so they can also ask in Hindi. So I'll respond to them in Hindi session. So what I'll do is I'll sum up the remaining four steps before I switch over to the Hindi session. Yes, can we go to this slide? Okay, we are there. The other one, Panduji. Bihari Nandanji, can we go back one slide?
Yes. This?
Yes. No, this is one more. Yes.
Yesterday also I had this doubt. 6A. A feeling of relationship or feeling of opposition, feeling of harmony or feeling of disharmony, feeling of coexistence or feeling of struggle. If one more time it is explained, it will be of much use to me. Relationship, harmony, coexistence.
So we can start with relationship. When we are saying relationship, it means relating to the other in a mutually fulfilling manner.
Okay.
When we say feeling of opposition.
Relationship with one more human being.
Relationship with any other unit in existence.
Okay.
And this can be broadly divided into two parts. One is relationship with human being. And the other is relationship with rest of the units in nature other okay. than human being.
Okay.
So we want to be related to the other in a mutually fulfilling manner, or we want to be related to the other in a mutually denying each other manner. So when you have a feeling of relationship, it means that I want to relate to the other in a manner which is fulfilling for me and fulfilling for the other. Feeling of opposition means I want to harm the other. I want to deny the other. And when I am thinking of denying the other, ultimately I am denying myself, because this is something which is not naturally acceptable to me.
Yes.
So this is the difference between feeling of relationship and feeling of opposition. Is that clear?
Can I put one more this thing, sir? Relationship my relationship of myself with other human being as well as other units in the existence or entity, universe. So that is the relationship. Okay. How to make that a fulfilling one is the exploration.
Yes.
Continuously and observing whether it is in relationship or in opposition. Okay. Yes, sir.
Yes. And the important difference between the two, the relationship with human being and the relationship with other units in nature, the main difference is that when it comes to the relationship with human being, it is focused on relationship between oneself and the other self.
Yes.
And therefore, what becomes important there is the feeling. The feeling that I had for the other human being, the other self, and feeling that is communicated to the other self. That becomes important. When it comes to relationship with rest of the units in nature, other than human being, what primarily becomes important is my fulfillment in terms of the material things. That is the difference. For example, if I have to feel my relationship with other human beings, these feelings of trust, respect, affection, they become very important. They are central. But when I'm thinking in terms of fulfilling my relationship with a tree, I have to have this feeling of mutual fulfillment. But whenever I want to execute this, express this, I have to express it in terms of doing something physical for the tree, right? Okay. Like giving water, giving manure, right? You know, ensuring that there is enough sun, you know. All this is something which I have to do physically.
Okay.
So that is the difference between the relationship, you know, among human being and the relationship with rest of nature.
Okay.
But both of them are a relationship of mutually fulfillment, you know, mutual fulfillment.
Okay.
I'm having a feeling of nurturing the tree, right? So I'm nurturing the tree. The tree is also nurturing me, my body. So that mutual fulfillment is there. In case of human being, this mutual fulfillment is primarily, you know, centered around the feeling. In case of the rest of units in nature, it is centered around the physical activity. Yeah, that is the difference.
Okay.
So this is about relationship and opposition, feeling of relationship and feeling of opposition.
Opposition, yes, yes.
Then feeling of harmony or disharmony. Now, what is my feeling about myself, about the other? Do I think in terms of ensuring harmony in myself, harmony in the other, or I think in terms of disharmony, contradiction in myself, in the other? So I want to disturb the other, or I want the other to be in harmony. What is my basic concern? What is my basic feeling? So today, if you see, if you look at yourself, when you get disturbed, right? You get angry, you want to disturb the other.
Okay.
Isn't it? You start shouting at the other. Is it going to disturb the other? Or is it going to bring the other in harmony?
Yes. Disharmony.
Right? It will create disharmony in the other.
Okay.
So that means I have a feeling of disharmony for the other, not feeling of harmony. And I am disturbing myself. So somewhere I am also disturbing my harmony.
Okay.
So deep down, if I had this feeling of, you know, being in harmony in my, you know, within myself, being in harmony with the other, creating harmony for the other, that we are calling feeling of harmony.
Okay.
If I am creating contradiction for myself, creating contradiction for the other, deep down I have that feeling of, you know, disharmony, feeling of contradiction for myself, for other. Right? Similarly, do I see myself in coexistence? Or do I see myself in struggle with, you know, other units in nature, in existence? And also, am I able to see this coexistence in space? Or I'm not able to see that coexistence in space? So this is the third thing. So when you, if you look at the difference between this relationship and coexistence, the basic difference is that when you are talking about relationship, we are talking about relationship between one unit and the other unit.
Okay.
When you are talking about the coexistence, you are basically talking about the relationship of an unit in space. So that, you know, it is important to identify the relationship of the unit in space. Because when I am able to see this, I am able to also see that every unit is related to every other unit through space. Because there is a space in between, right?
Yes.
Any two unit. So ultimately, if I have to see the relationship between two units, I have to see the relationship of the unit in space. Because there is space in between.
Okay.
So that is why this coexistence is brought in. So there is, you know, relationship of the unit in space. There is relationship of one unit with the other unit. There is relationship of one unit with every other unit. So when we are talking about relationship between units and units, it is, we are talking, saying in relationship. When we are talking about the relationship of the unit in space, we are calling it coexistence. Yes. And if we are not able to see this unit, you know, relationship of unit in space, then we start seeing these units as separate units, isolated units.
Okay.
And many times these units we see in opposition. If I'm not able to see the coexistence, I end up seeing this struggle. Yes, that is the point.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Yeah, this is Pave. Sir, this is regarding step one, sir. First, we are telling that observe the feeling without disturbing it or without trying to change it. So how long that should be? Because in some activity, some action, if we are just observing it, the thing may go in a different way. So just when I am observing, it is not right or not naturally acceptable to me. Then I can change or things like the third step or second step, we are asking, we have to evaluate whether the feeling is naturally acceptable to me or not. So you can give some clarity on this.
Yeah, you know, the interesting thing is that if you really see the reality, observe the reality without reaction, that is step one, right?
Yes.
And one of the realities, my imagination, my feeling, my thought, right? Now, when I'm observing this reality without reaction, things happen. I don't have to do it. It happens. So if I can do this step one very consistently, the step two will start happening. Step three will start happening.
Okay.
We have purposely kept them as separate steps. Because initially when you are trying to work it out, it is better that you are doing it in steps.
Okay.
But if you are able to do this step one, you know, properly. That is, you are observing your feeling, your thought, your expectation is at this moment.
Yes.
And you are not reacting to it. You are just observing. If you do this, step two will start happening.
Okay.
you will be able to see whether it is naturally acceptable to you, not naturally acceptable. Mm. You will also be able to see whether it is, you know, giving rise to a state of comfort within or discomfort within.
Mm.
A state of harmony within or disharmony within, contradiction within.
Mm.
A state of happiness within or unhappiness within. Now, you don't have to do it, you know, very, you know, with lot of effort.
Mm.
It will just start happening. So if I am in step one without getting disturbed, without getting to react, right?
Mm.
Things will start happening. Step two will start happening. Step three will start happening.
Okay.
Right.
Okay. Okay. So we are talking about that reacting for that feeling.
Yeah.
That we should not do. Okay.
When we start reacting, then we are not observing.
Fine.
Now we are busy in reaction.
Yes.
Right.
But now I could observe when some thought is coming, when we are seeing some person is coming, immediately some preconditioning is starting in my mind. But instantaneously, I can see I am thinking about the preconditioning. It is not so. So like that, now I can see that changes.
Yeah, and this is not a matter of thinking.
Mm.
But it should be clear.
Okay.
This is seeing things from the place of pure observer.
Mm.
So it is not thinking. I'm not thinking whether this feeling is naturally acceptable to me or not naturally acceptable to me.
Okay.
Mm. When I'm there at the level of pure observer, I look at the feeling and I can see that it is naturally acceptable or not naturally acceptable. This is not out of thinking.
Okay.
Right?
Okay. Okay, fine. Sir,
it is important to see that this is not thinking. This is not a matter of thinking. It is a matter of direct observation at the level of pure observer. So it is above this feeling, above this, you know, trying to understand things. It is just direct observation.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. What I'm trying to say is the next feeling.
Mm. Just a minute. When you are making this direct observation, right, you don't have to react. If you come down to a lower state of your activity, then your sanskara starts working and you may react. So reaction means that you have come down to the lower activities. And therefore, you have some sanskar there. And on the basis of that sanskar, you are reacting. At the level of pure observer, you can observe and you don't need to react. So not reacting is also a kind of verification that I am not at the level of lower activities of the self. I am at the level of, you know, the activity of pure observer. The highest activity. So you don't have to wait, you know. You have to be this pure observer. That is, you have to start observing without reaction. Then things will start happening. This pure observer is able to see what is natural, what is not natural. Right? It is able to see which feeling is leading to state of harmony and happiness, which feeling is leading to state of disharmony and unhappiness. So all these things will start happening. Initially, we are doing it, you know, by effort because we are not, you know, used to it. We have been used to working at the lower activities, you know, of the self. So just to draw your attention, this effort is being made. But once you are there, as pure observer, and from there you are looking things, then you don't have to much, you know, don't have to make effort there. It will start happening.
Okay. Sir, one more thing. Outside this exercise, actually, we are handling UHV2.
Let me clarify this.
Yes,
that
sir.
Is step 7A. Right? Where we are saying, ensure that at this moment of time, you know, you have this feeling of relationship, harmony, and coexistence, and not otherwise. Okay, even this is step 7A will start happening. Right?
Yes.
All that you have to do essentially is to be at the level of pure observer, which means you have to be in step 1, okay, in continuity. That's it.
Okay.
So if you can be in step 1 in continuity, it other things keep happening.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah. You had another question.
Yes, sir. Sir, in UHV2, higher activities guiding thought. In that part, I'm having one slide. Tasty, necessary, arrow, tasty, unnecessary, arrow, tasteless, unnecessary, arrow, intolerable. I could not understand this. How to take it in the class to the students?
Take to the students.
We are handling UHV2, sir. In that, we are having this higher activities guiding lower activities. One slide.
Yeah. So what it says is very simple. Can we have that slide, Rajalvia?
Yes, sir. I will just show on that slide. I will take one minute.
So what it is saying is very simple. And the experiment that the students can do is also very simple, right? Ask them to collect whatever they consider very tasty for themselves, right? Let us say some sweet, okay? In sufficient amount, more than what they can eat. And ask them to start eating it.
Okay.
Okay. Let us say rasgulla, you know, is a favorite sweet. So you collect enough rasgulla, sit down and start eating that rasgulla. Okay. Initially, it will seem to be tasty and necessary.
Okay.
After your stomach is filled, you know, full, you can see that it is unnecessary. Not this. Niche. Lowest one, yes. So after your stomach is full, it is, you know, it appears to be unnecessary, so it is tasty. Okay?
Yes.
Yes. When it is full up to the neck, then it is unnecessary, of course, and it also loses the taste.
Yes.
It becomes tasteless.
Okay.
Now you don't want to eat anymore. But if somebody is forcing you to eat,
fine.
It will become intolerable.
Fine.
So let every student do the experiment for themselves.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Actually, we are referring to your videos, and with that help only, we are handling this subject. We have not undergone that UHV, that is refresher 2 workshops. So with the help of your PPTs presentations only, we are doing this in the classes. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
We are trying to arrange for this workshops now.
Yes, sir.
Refresher 1, part 2.
Yes, sir. Yes.
You know,
yes.
Little more equipped.
Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Good morning, sir. I am Priya.
Yes.
Sir, yesterday you were telling about law of consciousness, no? So is it the same, these steps? Because that word I'm hearing for the first time. And one more question is...
what is the word you used?
Law of consciousness. Consciousness. And another question, sir. You were telling, no, with the close relatives, you should have a feel, you should have the feeling, if it feeling of relationship, if it is coming only in the thought process and some more word use, it will not work out. But what I feel is to come to make it to the feeling part, we should start with the thought process, no? Because sometimes I am observing when the situation is not in favorable to us, suddenly in the mind that feeling, we feel little opposition feel that comes. Then from through the thought only, I understand that, no, I should not be in the feeling of opposition. I should not be in the opposition feeling. And then I should be in the relationship mode so that I will not react. So that is our second question, sir. I hope you understood the second one. Hello? Bhaiya, is my voice audible?
Yes, it is audible. Tell me, repeat the last sentence.
To have that feeling of relationship, no, sir. Sometimes it happens when the, of course, that feeling of relationship is there. But when some situation comes which is not very favorable to us, and it is that when I'm observing, I could feel that opposition feeling is coming. Then suddenly in the thought process, I think that I should not have that opposition feeling. I should have that relationship feeling. So yesterday you were telling with only by the thought process, it will not work out. You should have that feeling. So sometimes to bring that feeling, I have to go through the thought process. Then it comes.
Yeah.
It is not that feeling is not there continuously, that I'm observing it. Because that opposition feeling comes sometimes.
Yes.
So that's how to make it into that feeling of relationship. Always, it has improved, sir. But still, some situations when it comes, when other person is also, it's not me. When in the house, the person I am dealing. I might be having a relationship, but when other family members is having opposition to him because of his dealings, then I get little how to handle the situation, because I cannot make the other person to be in relationship, no? So that situation comes, a little confusion happens.
Yeah. See, okay, let me respond to the questions, you know, one by one. The first one is regarding these laws, you know. So I was mentioning yesterday that in the name of science, what we are talking about is the laws which are followed by the material things. Okay. We are not talking about the laws which are working with consciousness, right? Now, with this study that we have been doing in EHV, we can see that there are certain laws with which these material things are working, and there are certain laws with which this, you know, consciousness units are also working. So in the name of science, we should study both. Study the laws of material things and laws of consciousness units also. Isn't it?
Yes, sir. But we have not studied the law of consciousness till now. We have studied only the law of matter.
So Now that is what we are doing, you know. So I said, step one is, you know, we decide to pay attention to our own self, our own imagination, our own desire, thought, expectation. And when we decide to pay attention, we can pay attention. Right? This is one law of consciousness. When we pay attention, we can see it. When we see it, we can understand it. Right? Very simple, simple laws, isn't it?
Yes, yes, sir.
Yes. So this is what I was saying. Then I was saying that when I see myself, observe myself, I see the feeling that I have at this moment. Right? And I can also see whether it is naturally acceptable to me, not naturally acceptable to me. So this is another law. Then I can, when I observe this feeling, I can also see whether it is leading to a state of harmony and happiness or otherwise. Isn't it? So all these are happening in me because these are the laws of consciousness. I'm not creating these laws. This is the way the consciousness works. And I have to understand them. And if I can understand them, I can handle this consciousness properly. And we can see the problem is not of the material really much. The problem that we are facing today is the problem of consciousness. Isn't it? This unhappiness, this need for happiness, is the need of the consciousness. The state of unhappiness is the state of unhappiness of the self, of the consciousness. The problem is not at the level of material really. The problem is at the level of consciousness. And if we have to solve this problem at the level of consciousness, we have to understand the laws of consciousness. How it works. And once we understand these laws, then we can solve the problem. Solve this problem, which is basically the problem of consciousness, not the problem of material. This we are able to see, you know, unhappiness is there in me because my feeling has gone wrong. Isn't it?
Yes,
this is the problem of material or problem of consciousness?
Problem of consciousness. Consciousness.
So we have to help, you know, solve it at the level of consciousness. And to do that, I have to understand the laws of consciousness. Is it making sense?
Yes, sir. I understood. That I understood, sir. First question, yes. I understood.
Yes. Good. The second part I was saying, that if you look at this consciousness and if you want to find out the solution for the problems at the level of consciousness, ultimately where you have to work, working at the level of thought or working at the level of expectation, okay, is not enough. You cannot solve your problems at the level of working at the level of expectation and thought. Why? Because your thought, your expectation, and even your desire or feeling is guided by your understanding or preconditioning. So if you have a wrong preconditioning, right? Then you are stuck. The problem is that you are now guided by that preconditioning. And if that preconditioning has gone wrong, right? If you don't have the right understanding and you are going by preconditioning, and if that is sanskar, that is what we are calling. So if you have a wrong preconditioning, a wrong sanskar, then all this desire, thought, expectation will be guided by that. Guided or misguided. Now, working at the level of thought, at the level of expectation, and even at the level of desire, right, will not help you to come out of that preconditioning, because all these are guided by or misguided by the preconditioning. So what do? I have to move over, you know, this, you know, state where there is preconditioning, there is lack of understanding. So I have to move up to the level of pure observer, the highest activity of the self. Because the lower activities of the cells are guided by this preconditioning. So that is what I was saying. So I'm not saying that don't work at the level of thought to, you know, look at your feeling. You may start, you know, at the level of thought to, you know, get back to see what feeling you have at this moment and whether it is naturally acceptable, not naturally acceptable. So at the level of thought, you can conclude something about the feeling which was there at the base of it. But when you have to see whether this feeling is naturally acceptable or not naturally acceptable, that it cannot be done at the level of thought. You have to move up to the level of pure observer. And from there, you see whether it is naturally acceptable or not naturally acceptable. Because your thought is guided by the feeling, not the feeling is guided by the thought. And if you try to guide the feeling by thought, very soon you will get stuck. You will find that you are not able to do it. So many of us at the level of thought, you know, accept that I should not overeat, right? But if there is something tasty, you end up eating. Now what is happening? What is happening is that you have this feeling of getting happiness, right? Right? Ultimately, that feeling is there. That need for happiness is there. Okay. And you think that you will get happiness from the taste. Right? Therefore, you develop the expectation to get more and more taste from outside. And if there is something tasty, you end up eating it, even if it is overeating. So with your thought, you cannot control your feeling. There will be a lot of struggle within. So what we are saying is that we can move up to the level of pure observer. From there, we see what feelings are naturally acceptable, what feelings are not naturally acceptable. And therefore, settle that these are the feelings which I am going to have. Right? I am going to have the feeling of nurturing the body and not harming the body. Once I have that feeling, from there down, I will look at the thought. With that feeling of nurturing the body, now I will work out my thought. So if there is any thought, okay, which says, you know, get happiness through sensation, I will be able to see that it will not lead to, you know, continuity of happiness, because it will violate the very feeling of nurturing. I will start harming the body instead of nurturing the body. So like that, things have to be fixed at the level of pure observer. Has to be decided at the level of pure observer. Then fixed at the level of feeling. Then thoughts will start coming in place. Otherwise, we have all kinds of thoughts based on our preconditioning. But I'm not saying that don't do this, you know, at looking at your thought and from there conclude about your feeling. I mean, you can start with the, all that. But at some time, this clarity has to come. That thought cannot be the source of, you know, fixing your feelings. Soon you will find that sometime it is working and most of the time it is not working.
Sir, but actually there was one situation with my colleague. I have to talk a little harsh to her, but later on inside I was getting a feeling, like, you know, very awkward feeling that what I did was wrong. Then when I expressed that feeling, that I, of course, I'm sorry what I told, but then that is going to the thought process. That thought process is making me to tell the feelings, no, that I am feeling because of the feeling awkwardness. I told sorry, and then I got relaxed. So that means I have gone to the observer level, or since I've gone to the observer level with the feeling, so that I could tell, understood and tell sorry to it.
See, interesting thing is that you started with the thoughts, right?
Yeah, I started with the thoughts, and then
and you know, then you you paid attention to it, and you know, saw that the feeling you have is not natural for you, and all that.
Yeah.
So somewhere you went to that level of pure observer.
Okay.
But till then, what happened? Till then, all kind of feeling and thought took place, and you suffered.
Yeah, yeah.
So this suffering is there in between. So if you don't mind having that suffering in between, it is fine. But you want to solve it, you know, instantaneously, and in fact, proactively, then it is better to see this feeling beforehand.
Okay, before. Okay.
Now, if you see beforehand through your pure observer and fix it up, this feeling, then there is no chance of having thoughts otherwise. There is no chance of behavior otherwise. Isn't it?
Okay. Oh, okay. Okay, sir.
Interesting thing is that when I'm looking at the pure observer, I mean, at the level of pure observer, then I can fix once for all that for every human being, I will have feeling of relationship or feeling of opposition.
Yeah, feeling of relationship will come to all people.
For all, you know? So it is fixed once for all. Now there is this, no matter whether he is my blood relation or not blood relation. Right? Whether he is behaving properly or not behaving properly. My feeling is already fixed. Fixed on the basis of my observation at the level of pure observer. This is what we are talking about. You know.
Okay. Okay, sir. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Namaste, sir.
Namaste. Namaste.
Namaste. The very first one, first exercise, first point only.
Yes.
There we were doing this observing thing, observing the self by the self.
Yes.
Observing what is happening, whether we are in a relationship, harmony, coexistence. So my doubt or this thing is, we should not flow with the feelings. We should just observe the feelings. Right, sir? Right, sir?
Yes. We are saying that we should observe the feeling.
And we should understand.
And we should not react to it. We should not react to it. Yes.
So that is the ultimate and final this thing. It should happen continuously. that observation should be there. We should not react to that. We should just observe it, and we should be in relationship. That is the new this thing of concept of we want to be happy in continuity. That happy in continuity is there only when we have the feeling of relationship. Then we should be in the state of the harmony, and we should understand the coexistence. That
let
we
me,
are.
Let me state yes. this clearly.
Yeah.
We are not saying we should do this or that.
No.
We are saying that number one, we should be aware of our feeling.
Yes.
It, and we should be aware of it without reaction. That is number one.
Yes.
Then we are saying that we should be able to observe whether this feeling is naturally acceptable or not naturally acceptable.
Yes.
Then we need to check whether this feeling is leading to a state of harmony and happiness or disharmony and unhappiness.
Yes.
These are the main three steps.
Yes.
That is step 1, 2, 3.
Yes.
If we can do this without reaction, then what will happen in a very natural manner is that the feeling which are naturally acceptable to me start having the continuity. The feelings which are not naturally acceptable to me will start dying out. Okay. At least they will become very weak in of time. This is what we are saying in essence.
So the correction part should not happen. We should observe it, whether we are in the state of what you call relationship harmony. Right, sir. So my doubt is...
We are not saying correction should not happen.
No, sir.
We are saying correction
ideal situation
in a very natural manner.
That's what. Ideal situation is this.
Yes.
So we have to work out toward that. Then we can ensure happiness. All this should happen because we want to be in the state of what you call happiness or harmony.
Yes.
This is the ideal situation. We have to work out for that by observing. And
it's not the ideal,
but the reality.
Natural situation.
So, but day in and day out, means when we observe this, when we are shifting to the state of disharmony, no doubt we know the fact that the natural status is harmony, but we land in disharmony.
Yes.
So, see, after understanding that we should not react also, but we cannot be in that situation of, I don't know how to put it. When it is happening, the agitation will be there in the mind, then we should not react means how it is possible.
Yeah.
Like.
True. See, what we are saying is that we are not saying their reaction should not happen. We are saying that the situation today may be that you are reacting. But if you observe this reaction and your state of being, you will find that with that reaction, you are in a state of disharmony.
Yes. You are in a state of unhappiness.
Which you do not want to continue with.
Yes.
Okay. So what we are saying is that as long as you are working at the level of your sanskar, at the level of your preconditioning,
okay, yes, sir.
You are likely to have this problem.
Yes.
And therefore, you are having this problem. Now, what do we do? We are saying that whatever is the situation today, at this point of time, okay, I am observing that situation. Simply observing the situation of the self at this point of time. That I can do. Okay. And when I'm simply observing, okay, not reacting to it, I can further see whether the feeling I have at this moment in me is something which is naturally acceptable to me or not naturally acceptable to me. I can also evaluate whether it is leading to a state of harmony and happiness or otherwise. All that I have to do. Now, if I can do this at this moment, I will be in a state of harmony and happiness. Next moment, I might get lost, right?
Yes.
Which is fine. We are not saying, you know, don't get lost. We are saying if you get lost, fine, you know. Now see that you are lost. And then keep with your decision that you have to get back to your awareness. So after some time, you will come back to the, you know, to a state of awareness. In the meantime, all kind of things will happen, which is fine. Like I was telling somebody yesterday evening that when you are, when you start learning to walk, what happens? The child, you know, when it's learning, starting learning to walk, then it will be able to, you know, start, you know, putting effort on two legs, you know. It is able to walk one or two steps, you know, and again it gets back to this fourth, this thing, you know. Then second time, third time, you know, it will keep doing, and after some time it is able to walk on two legs, right? So there is no miracle in it. This is a natural phenomenon. Like that, we are now trying to be aware of our imagination, aware of our feeling, and then we are trying to find out whether this feeling is naturally acceptable, not naturally acceptable. So if I keep doing this much without reaction, then I find that things start changing in the self. Like over last 1 month, you must have been able to observe that some changes are taking place in your state of the self. No. If not 100%, at least 1%, you know, you are becoming, you know, more comfortable within, more harmony.
Yes,
okay.
It is
happening. Outside have not changed. Right?
Yes, sir.
But by simply trying to be observant, be aware, and evaluating your feeling, whether it is naturally acceptable, not naturally acceptable, whether it's leading to harmony and happiness or otherwise, now we are able to, you know, improve our situation just by this observation. Right. So even if it is taking place 1%, 0.5%, that means I can walk on two legs. This is possible. Only thing is now it is a matter of practice, matter of working with it.
But that journey is
happening, you know, this remaining 99% time, keep falling down, you know, and then walking on four legs, I mean, moving on four legs, and all that will happen. It is fine. Now, at least 1% I am able to handle. And if I can handle 1%, I can handle
that. That 1% I am able to achieve, sir, but that 99% is, again, it will go to the other status.
That is fine. Starts. But at least 1% I am able to solve now. And if I can solve 1%, I can solve remaining 99% also. But the thing is that we are so used to react, you know.
Yes, sir. Yes, that is.
So we start that has reacting become on the fact that, you know, 1% only I am able to walk on two legs, and then I am falling down. I think it is good that at least we are able to see the glimpse of this possibility, right?
Mm-hmm.
1% is very important.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Before that, we didn't even see the possibility that this is, you know, this kind of thing can happen.
Yes. Yes.
I can be my own master.
Mm-hmm.
But now I can see this possibility.
Yes. But if we stay reactionless, means if I don't know, other person will take it for granted. Again, I will go to that mode only. That mode.
We are only saying,
yes,
not to react. We are not saying don't respond.
Yes.
So when you stop reacting, okay, you don't become inactive. You start responding.
That response is also, yes, sir, yes.
Okay, like when you are asking something in a proper manner or improper manner, I don't react, but I respond, right? Yeah, so you will, it's not that you will become inactive or dead person. You will start responding to the situation rather than reacting to the situation. So you will do much better than what you are doing now.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, I understand the difference, but seeing the outside world, it is the way of life till now. Seeking the appreciation, other person should identify you, at least say some good things to you. There will be different groups of people who will be appreciating you, whether it is for real value or superfluous value. We feel comfortable with them. So again and again, we try to go to them only and try to get the appreciation part of it. We will avoid the people who will criticize your this thing. Or in that group, we feel, I don't know whether actually how to assess the people. So I stopped assessing the situation. So wherever that disharmony comes into picture, wherever that disturbance is there in my mind, I'll observe why this is happening, what is the reason, what is my part, just observing what should be my actual response to that, so that it will improve my competency. I think I am on the right path with your guidance. The journey is beautiful, but nothing concrete has happened till now. That is my assessment. I don't want to stop it at that point. I'm going in that path, observing, and what should be my correct path, without reacting to the other person. It is happening, as you told. Slowly, things will happen. 1 month, this improvement is enough. Then, if I continue in that, it will improve my competency, maybe.
Interestingly, you are saying nothing, you know, significant has happened. You know, what do you expect to
again
happen?
Again and again, it goes to the outside, this thing only. Why he should criticize me? Why he should?
This is the problem.
I mean, am I not correct? Am I not done my work correctly, like that?
If you look at within yourself, you think that there is something, you know, yourself has become better than before?
Yes, 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 yes.
Now, is it significant, sir, or not significant?
That 1% improvement is, I want to have things happen fast. I am acceptable for that, sir. I am acceptable.
Yes. Interestingly, you know, as you said right now, you are still looking for these things to happen outside.
Yes.
It will take time, because what has to happen is that first there will be change in me. There will be improvement in me.
Yes.
Then there will be improvement in my response.
Yes.
Then the other person will be able to observe that change in response.
Yes.
That will make him comfortable.
Yes.
Right. When he feels comfortable with you, then he will, you know, start sharing his, you know, doubts.
Yes, yes.
Or
yes.
his whatever, you know, questions he has with you.
Yes.
Then you can respond to his, you know, queries.
Yes.
What is happening now is that the other person is already in a position.
Yes.
He is pissed off with my behavior.
Yes.
Does not want to listen to me.
Yes, not worth sharing or not right? confiding like that.
Yeah. Even when I'm trying to say something, the other person is not listening.
Yes, yes, yes.
He is hearing your voice but not listening to you.
Yes.
Then yes. when he listens to your voice, he reflects over it, he works on himself or herself, then there will be change in the other. There are so many steps involved in between.
Yes.
But we are jumping, you know,
yes.
to that expectation of ours that things should change outside or changes should take place in the other. What we are saying is that let's look at ourselves and start working in ourselves.
Yes.
Then we will begin to see some changes in the self. That makes all the difference. For me, it is very significant.
Yes, sir.
Because ultimately, for my continuous happiness, the change has to take place in me.
Yes.
That is what we said. No? The happiness yes, is yes. our innate nature. Not an influence from outside.
Yes.
But we are too preconditioned to get the happiness as a result of some positive influence from outside. Yeah, that is our problem.
Yes. Previously, the journey was, I want to be in good books of all the persons. So now I have got my own book and I'm trying to observe what I am in my own books. Yes. Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you.
And then I will, you know, have the right kind of feeling for everyone around. So they will start also feeling comfortable.
Yes, yes, yes.
So they were seeking for good feeling from me. I did not have the good feeling in me. So I could not give it. I was seeking for the good feeling from the other. And they had, you know, no good feeling for me. So they couldn't make it available to me.
Yes, yes.
So everybody was a beggar. And everybody's bowel was empty.
Yes.
Right? So this is what happening, you know?
Yes, yes, sir. Yes, sir. I understand. That state of disharmony is coming again and again. I'm trying to avoid. It is not avoiding. What exactly the bottom of it, where that problem lies, what should be my response?
Yes.
I'm working on that. Yes.
Good. First, what should be my state of being?
Yes.
Second, what should be my response?
Mm.
So even this response comes second.
Yes.
First what comes is natural? My state of being, right?
Yes.
Whether I'm in a state of harmony and happiness or otherwise. That is important. And in order to say that, I have to see what feeling I have.
Yes. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Sri Lata ji.
Yes.
Yes, Geeta ji has something to share.
Ji, namaste ji.
Namaste.
Sabhi ko namaste. Ji, my doubt is with coexistence. Let me put it, ji.
Yes.
So coexistence means this planet is not only for human beings. This planet is for all living beings. So this is the highest level of coexistence. Then coming down with human beings, from birth to death, we are mutually dependent on others for all our activities. That is to say, I cannot live all alone in this world. I need to coexist with all other orders in this planet.
Yeah.
Because of this, since all human beings, they'll be having their own different ideas, thoughts. They may not be in alignment with my thought, my feeling, etc. I need to have right understanding in alignment with natural acceptance. Only then I'll be able to exist with all other human beings, with as well as with all other orders, in continuous happiness and prosperity. And for that, I need to work on myself. That is why we are drawing the important conclusion that self is central to human existence.
Yes.
But in context of whether we are referring coexistence in the same context, G, because this is what I have understood about coexistence, which we are using literally around. But whether the same context is used in UHV also for coexistence, that is my doubt, G.
Yeah, I had clarified this yesterday, but I can clarify it again. So normally when we are saying coexistence, it includes this. Includes this relationship between one unit and the other unit.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so the general usage of coexistence includes this relationship between one unit and the other unit. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
But when we are saying relationship, harmony and coexistence, okay, then what does it mean? Then let us start from this coexistence first. The coexistence here means the relationship of the unit in space. Okay. So this is broader than the relationship between one unit and the other unit. It includes the relationship of the unit in space. So this unit is there in space. And we need to understand this relationship also. Right? So when we are saying coexistence here, it means relationship of units in space. That we need to understand. When we understand this units in space, then we realize that every unit is in space. It is energized in space. It is self-organized in space. And it is related to other units, you know, in space and through space. So now if I see this coexistence means relationship of unit in space, which will include three things. Number one, the unit being energized in space. Number two, unit being self-organized in space, which would mean the unit is in harmony in space. And number three, the unit is in relationship with other units in space. So that is the meaning of coexistence, harmony, and relationship. And all these three are included in this coexistence. Okay. So coexistence word is used, you know, when you are using just coexistence, it is also used synonymously for relationship. But when you are saying coexistence, harmony and relationship, then coexistence is all inclusive. In the sense that it includes the relationship of a unit in a space. It includes this unit being self-organized, being in harmony in a space. And it includes that unit being in relationship with other units in a space.
Okay. So now we are using in a coexistence means we have to coexist with all other living beings. We have to go higher. Yes, G. Now I'm able to get it, G.
Yeah, but when you look at this, you know, step 7, for example, 6 and 7. When we are saying we have to, you know, have this feeling of relationship, harmony and coexistence, then what you are saying is included in this relationship itself. Then we have to go a little higher. We have to see that every unit is in harmony in its space. So I must be able to see for myself first that I am in harmony in its space. And then I should be able to see this for every unit. Then further, I must be able to see that I am in its space. Right? And in its space, I am energized, I am self-organized, and I'm able to see my relationship with every other unit in space. That is the meaning of feeling of coexistence. Yes. So I'm building up slowly. Relationship means I'm related to every unit. Harmony means I'm self-organized in space. Coexistence means all three. I'm in relationship with other units, I'm self-organized, and I'm in relationship with space also. Now this realization that in space I am energized, in space I am self-organized, in space I am related to the unit. This realization is a very important realization, because when I have this realization, I can see that all the needs of the self is fulfilled in space. That it is not dependent on other units. So as far as the need of the self is concerned, the need of the self is fulfilled by virtue of the self being in space, in coexistence in space. Now, when it relates to the world outside, the need of the body is related to the, you know, physical world outside. So this is a very important realization, that if I can see that I am in a coexistence in space, I am energized in space, I am self-organized in space, I am, you know, able to recognize my relationship with every unit and fulfill that relationship in space. If I can see this, I can see that I am in a state of self-organization. And I'm in a state of harmony and happiness, right? And therefore, my happiness is not dependent on getting something from outside. So this is the real sense of Svatantrata. Okay. So we can now see that my need of the self for continuous happiness is fulfilled in space. So I have nothing to get from anything from outside to for my happiness. On the other hand, when I have this realization of coexistence, harmony and relationship, then I can see the relationship, therefore I fulfill the relationship with the world around. So I have nothing to get from outside to for my happiness, but when I am in harmony and happiness within, I have, you know, the capacity to give to the outside. with that feeling of relationship. Previously, I was trying to get so many things from outside for my happiness, and I was not giving much. Now, I will not take anything from outside for my happiness. And because I have this understanding of relationship and feeling of relationship, I will give, you know, whatever I can give from, you know, to the outside. This is a complete sense of satyantra, complete sense of freedom, complete sense of bliss. So in that sense, that state, there is no possibility of disharmony, no possibility of unhappiness. As long as I am not able to see this, I think that I will get happiness from outside, some favorable condition from outside. And if that is not there, I become unhappy.
Guruji, thank you, Ji. I got better clarity, Ji. Thanks a lot.
Yes, thank you very much, Geeta Ji. We have Deepa Nair.
Yes, sir. Good morning, sir. Actually, morning. I have the same question as Geeta ma'am was asking related to the coexistence. As you were explaining the same thing yesterday also. So the doubt is like this, because relationship of the unit in the space is coexistence. So you explained it very well today, but I have some more doubt related with that. Actually, which are the units in the space? So if I see myself also as a unit in the space, so like me, all living beings and non-living beings, everything is there in the space.
Yeah.
Yes, air, water, and everything is there in the space. So everything around me, I need to have that harmony and I need to see that relationship. Is it like that?
Yeah.
Yes. So that case, if I need to see the continuous harmony in myself, I should never see any, if there is any issue with the outside world, it will affect my harmony also sometimes. So if there is any natural calamity or if there is something outside that can affect my harmony. So I don't know how to. So if I feel that relationship, so I thought maybe the relationship in the sense that as you just explained now, so I should have that harmony. I need to see that relationship among all the living beings and non-living beings. Like I should be able to give everything like that. Means say a mother is giving everything to the child because she feels that relationship without thinking about herself. She's seeing that relationship and she's giving everything. So the same way, I need to see the relationship with living beings, non-living beings, and that way. So in that case, if there is any problem outside world, it can affect my harmony.
See, there are few issues, you know, which we must be very clear. Number one is, what is my understanding of relationship, harmony, and coexistence? Number two, what is my feeling? Number three, what is my thought? Now, if you look at these three things, I can have this feeling of relationship, harmony, and coexistence, right? For the whole existence, for every unit in existence. Now, when it comes to expressing it outside in terms of my behavior, in terms of my work, in terms of my participation, then the body is involved. Right, physical world is involved. So there will be limitation. So as far as the world of consciousness is, you know, concerned, that limit, deadness is not there. You can have this understanding and feeling and thought for the whole existence. But when it comes to doing it with the world, with the through the body, with the world outside, then you cannot do it for the existence as a whole. Right?
Yes.
That we must realize. So I will do with a few who are around me. I mean, I can nurture some of the plants around me, but I cannot go about nurturing all the plants in all the forests, right? So, but as far as my feeling is concerned, yes, I have this feeling of relationship with every plant, you know, every tree. So this clarity has to be there. That is number one. Number two, when I can see that there is harmony in every unit in space, okay, but there is some process of change when this unit is going from one state to another state. So during that change process, there is some, you know, disturbance. There is an excited state in between. So if I can understand this, I don't get disturbed with these changes taking place outside. I understand them and I can decide what is my participation in that process of change. For example, when we are trying to become aware of our imagination, our feeling, right? Now, many people think that this problem was there even before, but now that I've become aware, it has increased my unhappiness. So all this kind of thing will happen, you know. You have feel that you have become unhappier because now you're aware of this, all these things happening there. So I cannot start worrying about this, that, you know, people are becoming unhappier, or they feel that they have become unhappier. I know this is the process of change. When you start becoming aware of it, of yourself, you see that you are unhappy most of the time. You were unhappy even before, but now you have become aware of it. So you think that unhappiness has increased. So all this will happen. So you will not get disturbed by that. Right? In fact, you will facilitate the process. You will try to work out the way in which more and more people become aware of themselves. Isn't it?
Yes, so that means I need to be aware about my limitations and I have to work on myself. Yes.
Yes. Yes. So as far as expressing it in the outside world is concerned, there is limitation, yes, which I should understand.
Yeah, even though I see that relationship with the outside world, I need to aware about my limitations and I have to work on myself. Yes, I understood. Because I was thinking that if I see that relationship, I may get disturbed. Yes. Yeah. So, but I need to keep myself a little bit away. Yes, as an observer, I need to see everything. And I can work on myself and need to be aware about my limitations and that way I'll be able to improve myself. Is it like that, sir?
Yes.
Yes.
So, for example, we are able to connect to some 300-400 people, you know, every day morning. Right? But our feeling is that everybody in this existence, every human being in this existence, must develop right understanding and right feeling and right thoughts. But we are not able to ensure it for everybody. Right? We are able to do it for some 300-400 people who are connected. So every day morning we are able to work with them. But because we have this feeling, you know, in due course of time, we tried to bring it to the mainstream education so that we can set up a process in which, you know, this can go on generation after generation. But when we are doing it, we are not doing it with all the students, all the teachers, right? We are doing it with some teachers, you know, like we started with the professional colleges with their teachers. So there are around 6 lakhs teachers in professional education also, but we are able to reach only to around 70,000 people. But that is fine, you know. I mean, we could reach to a significant number. That is because these online facilities are available now. Otherwise, we would not have been able to reach even to, you know, 20,000 people. So, with whatever, you know, limitations are there in the level of our expression with the world outside, that we have to understand and work with that rather than getting unhappy about it. But as far as the feeling is concerned, it will be there for everyone.
Yes.
Yes. Everyone whom we know, we don't know, we have thought of, we have not even thought of. No, but every human being needs this right understanding. And therefore, as far as I am concerned, I will have the feeling of relationship with everyone, and I will think in terms of how to make it available to everyone. But then it does not mean that I will be able to make it available to everyone. But I can understand the process. I can develop the process by which it can start happening.
Yes, so that means understanding in its completeness is the keyword in 6B. So if I understand it's in in its completeness, I'll be able to see my involvement in a particular situation and I'll act accordingly.
Yes.
Yes. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. This is really a very good insight for me, because yesterday also I was a bit confused. And thank you, sir.
Thank you. Yes. Okay.
So when I look at into myself, the right understanding is the... First, we have to understand. So if I have a right understand, when I follow that right understand, then there is no conflict in myself. If I have a lack of right understand, then only there is conflict in myself, I have seen. So here, the right understanding means so see the reality as it is. So here we have to see the drishti gocharam and jnana gocharam. We have to see the roop, guna and coexistence, and dharma, paramadharma and swabhav, what they have given. So I couldn't understand this dharma and paramadharma. Because of that, maybe I'm struggling. So where I have to put effort to look at this dharma and paramadharma? This is my question.
Yeah. So, I mean, we should not get, into this technical terms too much. Let us try to understand these things. The approach that we are taking in this exercise one is very simple. We are saying that can we see ourselves?
Yes, yes.
So when we go to see ourselves, we find that it is possible for us to see our feelings, our thought, right? That is one very simple thing that we can do. So are you able to see your imagination, your feeling, your thought?
Yes, I can able to see.
Okay. Second thing we are saying that can we find out whether this feeling is naturally acceptable to me or not naturally acceptable to me?
Yes.
Third is, can I see whether this feeling is leading to a state of harmony and happiness or otherwise?
Yes.
Yeah, so these simple things we are doing first.
Okay.
Right. Then we are asking, which feeling is naturally acceptable to me? Feeling of relationship or opposition?
Yes.
Harmony or disharmony? Coexistence or struggle?
Yes.
Okay. So, if I can see this, then I will say that this feeling of relationship is something which is natural for me. The feeling of opposition is something which is unnatural.
Yes.
Okay. Can I see this?
Yes.
So this is what is called as swabhav.
Okay.
As natural characteristic.
Okay.
Right? So that becomes a technical term.
Okay.
Natural characteristics of how, you know. So I can see what feeling is natural for me, and that is my swabhav.
Okay.
And I can see that when I am in, I am having this feeling of relationship, I am comfortable within. Right? I am in a state of harmony within. I am in a state of happiness within. Can I see this?
Yes.
Okay. That is my dharma.
Okay.
So can you understand it now?
Yes.
So this, if you look at the self, right? The self is in harmony when it has the right feeling. Okay.
Exactly.
And yes. This right feeling can be ensured on the basis of understanding, you know, right understanding.
Yeah,
on the basis of seeing the fact that what is naturally acceptable to me is the feeling of relationship, harmony, and coexistence, and not otherwise.
Yeah.
So with right understanding, I am in a state of harmony within. And with right understanding, I have the right feeling. And with this right understanding and right feeling, I am in state of harmony within, in a state of happiness within. This I can see, isn't it?
Yes.
That being in harmony is happiness. This being in harmony is what is dharma.
Okay.
Can you understand it now?
Yes.
So that is swabhav and dharma.
So it is like this for us. What about the other unit?
Yeah. Swabhav is the participation. Natural characteristic is the participation.
Okay.
So my participation with other human being is to have this feeling of relationship.
Okay.
My participation with any other unit in nature is to have this feeling of relationship. That is my participation.
Okay.
That is my swabhav. So if I'm looking at any other unit, I will try to see what is the participation of that particular unit with other units. That will be the natural characteristic of that unit. Right?
Okay. I got it now.
Yes. Similarly, regarding this dharma, I will try to find out what is the you know, state of being in harmony of that particular unit. Like for us, being in harmony is to have the right understanding, right feeling, and therefore, you know, being in harmony and happiness. That is my, you know, state of being in harmony. So that is my dharma. If I take anything else, I will have to find out what is, you know, the state of being in harmony for that particular unit. So, for example, if I take a tree, it is, you know, the basic dharma of the tree is growth. So whenever this unit of tree is in harmony, you know, it shows in terms of the growth of the tree. Okay. So we are saying growth is something which cannot be, you know, isolated from the tree. If there is a tree, if it is in harmony, you can see the growth. There will be growth. The only way to stop growth is to, you know, convert it into something else, you know, no more remaining a tree. So you cut the tree and becomes wood, you know. So it is not a tree anymore. It is not a bio order anymore.
Yes, yes.
So we can start seeing these things directly, you know, with our direct observation. In that case, we will be able to understand these things better, rather than trying to understand them in terms of some definitions and some other words. We have to start seeing them directly by our direct observation.
Yes.
Yes. But it is better to start looking within ourselves and try to understand the basic harmony of the self, the basic, you know, natural characteristic of the self. If I can do that, then I can easily understand the natural characteristic, the innateness of other units.
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you, Ganeshji. I got it. Where I have to work.
Yeah, it takes time. It will still take time with you to look at this self and get all this clarity. But it is good to start, you know, this process.
Yes, yes.
Yes.
Lot of change I have seen within myself after working on it, look at into self and every moment and extending this moment to next moment, whatever what given. Really it is working.
Yes, and this is interesting to see, you know, that just having the right feeling in yes. myself makes so much of difference.
Yes, yes.
Just having the right understanding and right feeling in myself makes so much of difference.
Yes, yes. Really.
While the things outside are more or less the same. But because the things within have changed, this right understanding, right feeling has taken, you know, is taking place, it is making so much of difference. Even just change in the feeling, you know,
yes,
makes so
yes.
much of difference. And when I have the right understanding, these feelings become more, you know, definite, more in yes. continuity. So when I observe the self properly and work with the self, it makes all the difference. I can see how important is this feeling, how important is my thought, how important is my understanding.
Yes.
So when you say the basic innateness of human being is to be in a state of continuous happiness, right? Now you can slowly start understanding this.
Yes, yes. Now I'm able to see where I have struggling, first of all.
Yes. So till now we thought that the trouble is outside.
Yeah, yeah.
And we were trying to solve it. Now we understand that trouble is not only outside, but it is also inside.
Yes, yes.
And if I start working on myself, I can at least solve the problem inside.
Yeah, yeah.
Sure. In my hands.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Actually, what I am doing is to come out of the struggle inside, I am looking outside. But yes. It is not at all happening. And, yes. So with this knowledge, I am walking inside.
Yes.
This is happening. Really, I am very thankful to you, Ganeshji, in this UHV, helping me a lot.
In fact, you know, when I don't look inside and try to solve it there, and I try to solve it outside, it tends to get more complicated.
Yes, yes.
And that is what we are doing as a civilization.
Yes.
Today, as a civilization, what is happening is that there are problems outside and inside.
Yeah. Right?
And we are not looking within and solving it inside. We think that if we can solve the problem outside, it will be okay.
Yes, yes.
And then it is getting more complicated.
Yes, yes. Exactly.
From bad to worse. So somewhere we have to make up our mind that, okay, there are problems outside, but there are also problems inside. And it is within my capacity to solve these problems, you know, which are there inside. So I can start working on it. And when I start working inside and I'm able to solve the problems within, then I see that a large number of problems outside are already automatically solved.
Yes, yes, yes.
And then I become competent to solve the remaining problems outside.
Yes.
So I can start working on that.
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Bhavaniji. Yes. We have... Tara Prashna was there, no? Who was there?
Prabhakaranji.
Arunachalan, huh?
Prabhakaranji was there.
Prabhakaranji, yes.
Good morning, Ganeshji.
Good morning.
Dr. Sharmila, madam. Good morning.
Good morning.
Yeah, good morning to everyone. Ganeshji, as rightly you said right now, that the problem are there within us and the problem are there outside other people also. But it happened yesterday, one incident to me, that when I was gone for the filling up my vehicle, the fuel filling station there, they said immediately, you know, I want to get 2 liters of fuel. Immediately the person was asking me whether it is cash or card. I said, why you are asking? Anything is possible by me. So then started a problem. The other, his supervisor came, rushed, and you should not talk like that. You should answer when we ask for card or cash. Like, no, why you are asking? I said again. They said, no, if it is cash, then you may not be having the change. We may not be having the change. That's what they said. Really the kids, it's heated up, and I said, it is your duty, whether we are getting in cash or anything, you should solve it. Like every time, you should not expect that exact changes from us. You also should render the changes as a businessman. Like that it got. See, why I initiated that basically I was having the there is a point that if they are filling it in on cash basis, then the quantity at the last minute will be reduced automatically. That's what they said normally. It is only preconditioning from my side. Many people have said like that. So you should not ask for fill it for 500 rupees or fill it for 300 rupees. No, you should fill it for the volume basis, like 2 liters, 3 liters. If they key in that parameter at the system on volume basis, then the quantity will be perfect. That's what the people, in fact, authority from the inspection of fuel stations have already told me. So on that basis only, I asked them. The moment we touch upon their issue, their problem, whatever they are maintaining for their earning, then they got heated up. So my stand yesterday was to ensure the their procedure in line with the natural acceptance. So I just started heated up by making that his harmony was disturbed, my harmony was disturbed, and instead if I would have kept quiet when the person asked for it, yes, I had a card like that, then you should have maintained both the people's self as well as the other self's harmony. Would not have been a problem. At least I would have maintained my harmony for a few moments when I was going for the my profession. So this is, I try to keep it more calm in such instances, but it arouses me. So, Ganeshji, I wanted your opinion on that comment.
Yeah, this, as I said, we have to understand this, that there are problems outside, there are problems inside. Now, am I able to fix this problem inside?
Now, yes, it's possible.
In this case, there is an issue of procedure regarding the physical things outside, right?
Yes, yes, sir.
Yes. But there is a procedure inside also, right?
Yeah.
Procedure regarding the self,
Yeah.
So if I see this man who is delivering this petrol, now am I related to him? Do I have a feeling of relationship with him? Now this is one procedure which has to be completed.
Okay.
I don't complete this procedure, right?
Correct. We just skip it. We just skip it. We don't think in that manner. Correct. You are right, sir.
Yeah, not only that, you said, you had this input from agencies telling you that these people are cheaters.
Yes.
Yeah. So you had a feeling of opposition at the base.
Correct. Very strong opposition.
Yes. So we are only completing the part of the procedure, procedure regarding the material world. We are not able to see that well before that there is a procedure relating to the world of consciousness. That is what I was saying, that there are certain basic laws relating to the world of material. And there are certain basic laws relating to the world of consciousness. Unfortunately, today, in the name of science, we are only focusing on the laws related to the material world. And we are not paying any heed to the laws related to the world of consciousness. So all that we are saying is that, okay, let's understand this consciousness. And this we can do by direct observation. Then let us try to understand the rules of consciousness. consciousness. And if I have to interact with any human being, I have to first take care of the laws of, and then I can take care of the laws of material. Unfortunately, today we are not understanding these laws of material consciousness. We are not completing that procedure. And then we want to, you know, ensure the procedure relating to the world of material. And that becomes very difficult. Becomes very difficult for every one of us. Right? Can you see this?
Yeah. Yeah, I can understand exactly. But one thing, sir, can I interfere, sir? Can I interfere, G? Yeah, I understand. I accept everything. Yeah. But one thing, from our side, it's okay. But when this thing, procedural thing, which is not in accordance with the natural acceptance, will be solved, will come to the normal. See, yeah. We are paying after all. It's pinching our pocket, right? So it's our tendency to establish the procedure. I mean, the single person cannot change the entire nation's filling stations, people's procedure. We cannot. It's not possible. But still, if we continue to keep watching the thing which is not in accordance with the natural acceptance, as a human being, how can we surpass it, sir? It is my ambition.
I'm not saying that you don't follow the procedure in the world outside. I'm saying that first ensure this procedure,
within us,
the world of consciousness. So establish this relationship with that person with whom you had the problem, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I'm not saying go around the world and fix it.
Yeah.
I'm saying first fix it with yourself.
Okay.
Then fix it with this another consciousness unit with whom you are interacting.
Yeah.
Then we can fix up this, procedure related to the world of material. That is what I'm saying.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Yes. I'm not asking you to go all around the world and fix up. In fact, we are not fixing up the problem by doing all this. We are, in fact, creating more problems.
Yeah. Sir. Yeah.
Yeah. So it is the other way, like if there is a person there, with whom you feel related and he feels related to you, okay, things will just change.
Okay.
Things will just change. He will not try to cheat you and you will not doubt him. Right? He will think in terms of facilitating you.
Yeah.
Right.
Sir, right. I'm not having the feeling of opposition with the person who is delivering the petrol. The thing is, the procedure under which he has been instructed like that. So the procedure only I'm talking about. So that only makes me to...
We are having the feeling of opposition of all these people, not only this person.
Oh, the procedure also.
Yeah. But procedure means you think, what is this procedure? Who is delivering the procedure?
This it's people, like a human being, other
these people. Yes. And you think all these people are, thieves. Yeah. That is the feeling that we have generated all around with so-called, modernity and so-called, so much of information technology.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yes. Thank you, Jay. You have clarified my ambition. Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you, Jay. Good day.
Prabhakaran ji.
Ganesh, there are a couple more hands raised.
Okay. You can take up some of them.
Ji.
Yes. We have Tara Prashna ji and then we have Nidhi ji. Nidhi ji had some question yesterday also, but we could not respond. Yes.
Sir, may I put, sir?
Yes, yes, please.
Namaste, sir. Namaste, Didi. Sir, actually, when it was first proposed that happiness is can be continuous, so it was looking like a theory to me, but on the means all the steps, exercise and long journey with EVHB, it finally resulted that yes, I can see, I can even feel that this happiness is continuous and it can be an innate nature. But certainly, like what you are saying, or what the proposal is, we can see we are being related to all. So in this particular like feeling of relationship to all, I'm struggling a bit, like even the last sharings. So when we think of being related to all, in the family level, it's quite possible. And little bit in the workplace, and the innate nature, it can be seen clearly, like for anywhere, any incident or mishap, then definitely the feeling is going on like, yes, why is it is so happened, or that thing is, that can be seen, but it is still yet to explore, or it still to see that, you know, I can feel at each moment or in a continuous manner, like I'm being related to other, or other feeling of relationship with the others. So that is one question, that how can we further explore, or how can we make it innate nature, that being related to all, it should come to ourselves. The next is, sir, it is all the seven steps here we are discussing. So most of that means the, if I will take the summary, or if I will say the final thing, is guiding the self on the basis of natural acceptance. And now it is also like I can see that most of the time we are taking the guidance of natural acceptance and all, but still we sleep, or still, I mean, sometime I may not able to take that decision, but suddenly it after a few minutes or few hours, the right understanding is coming, and it is nullifying all the issues. So sometime I have asked Sarmila Didi as well, and many other times also, like Ganeshji or any resource person, how they look into these things. Means is it happening to all the, even you people are experiencing, or you people are taking this content from much longer time and have developed these contents. So is it happening to all, or at some time it will never happen to us? Like we can feel continuously I am related to everyone, or feeling of relationship to all the time, and the guidance from the natural acceptance will be all the time. Sir, can you put some comments, sir?
Yes, I will respond.
Thank
to
you,
this
sir.
You know?
Yes, yes.
Yes. So it is happening. At least to me, it is still happening, you know, that sometime my deep-rooted, you know, preconditioning, you know, start working. I'm not able to be aware of myself. And when I'm not aware of myself, I'm not able to evaluate that, you know, preconditioning. And when it starts working, it has own, you know, feelings associated with it. Okay. So those moments are still there, and I'm still working on it. But I can see that, you know, I'm now becoming more and more aware of it, you know, and I am able to ensure this right feeling or the natural feeling in me, you know, in higher percentage of time than I was able to do before. So this is what I would say about your second question. It takes time and it will take time, and there is no hurry. But if I start working on it, certainly there is a, you know, continuous progress. So this is in response to your second question. Is that okay?
Yes, sir. If okay, but still the question is like, will it be possible that at certain point of time, the feeling of opposition will come never, and feeling of being related to it will come like in an innate nature, like it will come automatically.
Now, I can do some extrapolation and say that it has been, you know, this state of harmony and happiness has been, you know, increasing. So it may reach to a completion point. But that itself is enough, I would say, you know. What else? What is the way to know otherwise? Tell me.
Just to take the reference of people, those who are experiencing, you know, for longer period of time, like you and Didi and all resource persons. So I think in that way.
Yeah, so it is a longer time. I mean, at least I can tell about myself that it is not, you know, completed. The process is not completed in the sense that I'm not being aware of myself every moment and all the moments, right?
Yes, yes.
But whenever I'm aware of myself, whenever I'm, you know, verifying things on the basis of my natural acceptance and I'm ensuring the natural feelings in me, I am in a state of harmony and happiness. This I can see. And this I can ensure, you know, for myself. But there are still moments, you know, when this deep-rooted, you know, sanskar, deep-rooted preconditioning, you know, which are there in me, and I'm not able to see them and, you know, evaluate them and get rid of them. You know, they become active. And, you know, when they become active, and that is possible only when I'm not aware of, you know, myself at those moments, then, you know, this feeling may or may not be in line with my natural acceptance. But I can see that there are layers and layers of this sanskar, and I'm working on them, right? And things are improving. So that gives me an assurance that if I continue to work on it every moment, I will be able to ensure this state of harmony and this natural feeling, you know, in myself, and this harmony and happiness within myself. So that assurance is there. But when you ask me whether there will be continuity or not, I will say that I can only say yes by extrapolation, not by my direct experience.
Yes, yes, very true. Thank you. Thank you.
I have till now. With that, I can extrapolate and say that it seems to be possible. That if I'm able to look at all my sanskar, you know, which I've accumulated over a long period of time, and if I'm able to evaluate them, that is what we are saying, purification of our sanskar. That's what we said in the beginning of exercise. So if I am able to do that, you know, in its completeness, then yes, I will be aware of myself every moment. I will be able to verify, you know, for every feeling, you know, and ensure that it is a natural feeling. And then I can have the continuity of happiness. But if you ask me, am I experiencing it, this continuity of happiness? I would say no. No. If you ask me if there is there a progress, I would say yes. Do you see the possibility? Yes. How do you see the possibility? By extrapolation of what I have been experiencing over, you know, a long period of time.
Sir, thank you so much, sir. I realized what I put the question, and it is certainly like most of the time the continuity is maintained, and definitely the extrapolation will take us in the same way what we desire. Yes, sir. Thank you.
We are saying that we are the co-explorer.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yes. We are also exploring. You can also explore, and we can explore it together.
Yes.
We are in the journey.
Yes.
Yes. So this is about second question. About the first question, this is very interesting, you know, that can I have a feeling of relationship for everyone? The answer is yes. Can I ensure the mutual fulfillment? You know, once I have the feeling of relationship, I will, you know, think in terms of ensuring the mutual fulfillment, right? So can I ensure the mutual fulfillment with everyone? I would say no. Because if you are thinking in terms of fulfillment through your body, body has limitations. Right? So you can fulfill it with some people, you know, 5 people, 10 people, you know, 100 people, 1,000 people. But you can't go around the world to fulfill that relationship with everyone. But as far as the feeling is concerned, yes, I can have the feeling of relationship for everyone. That is what we are calling as feeling of love. But if you really see, interesting thing is that you are anyway not going to connect to everyone, you know. But if you have a wrong feeling for everyone or whoever that person is, the moment you have the wrong feeling, you suffer. So your happiness or unhappiness has to do with your feeling. So if you think that all these, you know, petrol people, you know, petrol pump, you know, people are, you know, rascals, okay, the cheaters, then you suffer with this feeling, you know, that is important. So even if you don't have a vehicle and you never go to fill that petrol, okay, you will be unhappy. Can you understand this?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Very true. Not only petrol, like many things which we do not accept, we normally make this feeling of opposition with them. And yes. In most of the time, I try to give a solution to me that, you know, it is the only reason for which we are taking this USB content within us and to forward to others so that these things can be minimized.
Yeah. So my, you know, issue for me is that I've never met this Tarapasna Das, right? And, you know, we are interacting through the net. And if he's asking a question, at that moment, I have to first check whether I have a feeling of relationship or feeling of opposition. So if I have a feeling of opposition for you, I will start suffering. So the moment you raise your hand to ask a question, I start doubting your intention. I think that, you know, you are going to trouble me. Right? Now this thought that you will trouble me or you are trying to trouble me comes because I already have a feeling of opposition. And with that feeling of opposition, I will suffer. On the other hand, if I have a feeling of relationship, my thought would be that he is a very genuine person and he's trying to understand. Every day morning he is there at 5:30, you know. And, you know, he's sincerely working on himself. So he has some genuine doubts and I must, you know, help him to see what he wants to see. You know, I must be a kind of, you know, help to him. So that will be my thought, but that thought comes on the basis of my feeling of relationship for you. So we have not met, you know, till now. We may not meet, you know, in future, but, and there is no physical transaction taking place between us, but my feeling for you makes me happy or unhappy, isn't it?
Yes, yes.
Yes. So this I can have, you know, this feeling I can have of relationship for you, for anybody I have not met or I have met. So this fulfillment of relationship will take place as and when we come in contact. But I can have this feeling in me all the time for every human being. And with that feeling, I am myself in a state of harmony and happiness, even if I don't know you, even I have never met you, if I have not interacted with you. On the other hand, if I have this feeling of opposition, then I will suffer, right? Even I have not met you, my suffering is there.
Sir, I will not take much time just to say one line last. Earlier, we used to say, basically, my father always tells, like, you know, he is very good. Means whomever he meets, he said he believes him or her in that way. And at home, we used to say, you know, you believe everyone. So everybody cheats you, so in that way. But currently, I can see this statement. This is the innate nature of the human being, that, you know, you believe everyone. We feel being related to everyone. So that is the good part of the self. So that is what I just have to say.
Yes. In fact, the moment you have a feeling of doubt on another, you are already cheated at the level of consciousness.
Yes. Yes.
And you have cheated yourself, nobody else.
Yeah. And this is now becoming a major part of our misunderstanding.
Yes.
So we take everyone, we start the relationship or whatever opposition on the basis of doubting in the beginning. Yes. Yes. Thank you.
So we hardly start with relationship, we start with opposition. Yes. So I'll take up sharing of Nidhiji, and then we have Kali Charanji, Rat Kali Charan Rat. Yes.
Namaste, sir.
Namaste.
Sir, I have one sharing and then one question. Sir, now I'm able to see that most of the times, I mean that percentage, I don't know, but most of the time, this harmony is felt within. So the moment I become aware what I am thinking, so immediately that feeling of relationship or opposition is felt. And if I am able to, if at that moment I feel that the other person is doing some wrong thing as per my notion, so then also it is becoming possible that I am able to maintain the feeling. And then I would tell myself that right now I have this feeling of relationship for this person, but the act which he is doing is not appropriate. So let me just tell him. And it is becoming possible that I am able to convey the message to that person. Earlier, it used to happen that I would just smile in front of them, and within this continuous dialogue used to go, ki, kya kar rahe hain, kaise kar rahe hain? So that now, at that level, things are very much settled. And that is why throughout the day, it feels much, much better. And with the second experience of the exercise, slowly, as you say, always those layers are getting opening up. So that is felt. That is my sharing. And I have a question, sir. Generally, it happens now that if I'm expecting for an answer, I keep on waiting, and I say myself that the answer will come to me gradually. I just have to be there. But this has happened that one of my professor colleague, he lost his wife. And like earlier, I did not cry and all. I was shocked, but I just consoled myself and said, I mean, it has happened. Now you just have to see how you can help that, sir. But the reason behind that was, one day I was taking the class of UHV2, and there we had this discussion about suicide and depression. And the students were like, abhi kahan ye sab hota hai, ma'am? Like that. We don't see it in our close proximity. But then when this happened, then I remembered that we were talking about it. And then I shared with my students that this is how in my known premises this has happened. But now I waited for this answer to come to me, but it has not come. Now I did not get exactly how should I convey sir, so that he is okay. Immediately I cannot tell him to attend workshop. He has two daughters, and every day he keeps the status of his wife on the WhatsApp and tells that he is missing her. Please come back, like that. So when I see the message, I feel like he must be in so much of pain. So now at immediate level, what should be the message? That I did not get after much thought over it. So I wanted help in this.
See, I mean, I can just give you a very distinct a very specific kind of suggestion, you know.
Yes, sir.
See, the ultimate issue is that we have to realize that as far as body is concerned, it is likely to change, because the change is the very nature of the body, of the whole material world. Okay. So this clarity has to come. This, till that comes, you know, all this is going to happen anyway. Right. So in the long run, if you ask me the solution, that is the solution. That I, you, everyone has to realize that, you know, whatever is of the nature of changing will change. And whatever is of the nature of permanent will remain there permanently in continuity. So this we have to understand anyway, sooner or later. Now, given this lack of understanding on his part, okay, he is anyway going to suffer. Okay. So what can I do? I can at least ensure right kind of behavior with him. And that right kind of behavior will be consoling for him. Because, you know, even when we are in deep grief, you know, we keep looking for, you know, such input from others, you know, which is comforting. So a right behavior on our part will console him, will, you know, make him comfortable. And when this right behavior is there and the other is feeling comfortable, then, you know, the other is willing to have a dialogue with you. And when the other is willing to have a dialogue with you, then you have to find out, you know, see, all of us are in a journey. So a whole lot of work we are already doing in ourselves. So when I talk to someone, I can get a feel of, you know, where does he stand, you know, and where I can help, you know, him or her to move to the next, you know, step. So if you are having that kind of, you know, awareness in yourself, and if the other person is having that comfortability with you, you know, this person will start opening up, and then you can see, you know, what is his state of sanskar, you know, presently, and, you know, kind of what can be next step for him or her. And if you can suggest, you know, to the other may start working on it. So that is what I think, you know, can be done. But unless I am able to relate to the other, or the other is able to relate to me, and unless I am able to evaluate him, you know, his sanskar, it is little difficult to give a specific solution. So this is what I have to say.
Yes, sir. This can be done, that as you said, at behavioral level. My behavior should be consoling to him, and later, once he is comfortable, slowly I can make him aware about this fact about self and body in some other form, maybe.
Yeah, see, certain things he must be already, you know, have experienced.
Yes.
Certain things he may not be clear. So that, you know, when we have the dialogue, we can slowly understand what is the status of, you know, the self, or understanding of the self. Then we can suggest the next step.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Yeah, we'll take up a question from Kali Charanji, and then I can just sum up a few points which I wanted to make before I hand over.
Namaste, bhaiya.
Yes, namaste.
Actually, of the two points, I want to say something that one brother told regarding that cheating, right? So here we have to first think about that. No doubt we can believe with all the community or all the people, but when the war coming to the cheating, here we have to focus on the war or the work on which they are giving, that is as a proposal. So the proper evaluation of the proposal is required now. Suppose they are doing in the office, right? And some work is coming where the possibility of as a cheating, right? So here the work is coming as a proposal. I feel this, right? So the work evaluation have to done properly by the self. Yes, na brother?
No, what is your question? I'm not very clear.
Not. It is not the question, sir. The before that once I told regarding that cheating, right?
Yes.
Right. The cheating is, I'm thinking that the cheating is coming on the proposal.
Yes.
Isn't it? The cheating means what? Cheating means on the either cheating on the work or on the relationship in term of certain activities.
Yeah.
Right, I feel that one. So in that activity, we have to properly evaluate the faith and the belief on the person is okay, no problem at all. As in the relationship, we can keep that one. But when the war coming that I am cheat me. Actually, he is not cheating. We are get cheated by them, because our self evaluation lacuna. We are thinking self lacuna is there. Yes, na sir. But that is my feeling, that we are blaming that he cheat me. Actually, he is not cheated. We are not properly evaluated the proposal or the understanding the proposal. Am I right, sir?
No, I'm not able to relate exactly. Right. I mean, the point that you are trying to make.
Right.
No, are you saying that
we are getting in the relationship, na? That yeah. Somebody cheat me. So the yeah. Cheating, what is coming with the activity only, na, sir? I think.
With the activity of?
The cheating, what? The cheat, right? On the relation, the cheat is coming with the activity. Or the proposal. On any proposal only a person get cheated, or with the emotional, he is blindly believe on that particular activity, that what he is giving or what he is offering or what he is giving the suggestion on that one, that is right. And believably, you can say that without evaluation, we believe on that activity. Okay, I will get it once more clearly, sir. the relationship, okay, the relationship we are maintaining with the self, okay?
Yeah.
Right. Second one, we are getting the, so we are telling sometimes that X person cheat me, right?
Yeah.
Right. Here the X person is cheating. Cheating means what? Cheating is through any activity. Suppose he has given any proposal, right? And we blindly believe on that one.
Yeah.
Without proper evaluation, we believe it and we will tell them, yes, I am with you, or I am doing this one, or I complete this one, or I support this one. Yes, na, sir?
Yeah.
Some these cases, we have not think about our self-consciousness, self-evaluation, and proper evaluation or understanding of the proposal.
Yeah.
Right. For that reason, the person, as we blindly believe on that particular relationship, the person get cheated. Am I right, sir?
Yeah.
Or any some addition you want to put here?
Yeah. So what I understand is that you are trying to say,
yeah,
that we are not able to evaluate the intention of the person and competence of the person.
Right. Blindly we believe on them.
Yeah. And we think that, you know, everybody has a good intention, and therefore he will also have the competence to fulfill that intention.
Yes.
And because I'm not able to evaluate his competence properly.
Right. And properly working, also on the proposal.
He is lacking competence.
Yes.
Therefore, he does something which is not in line with the intention.
Yes.
Right. So if I am getting cheated, then I have to do two things. Number one, I have to keep my intention clear.
Right.
And I should also have the clarity about his intention, which is always good. But then I must evaluate my competence, and I must evaluate the competence of the other. And on the basis of that, I should make the program.
Exactly, exactly, sir. This one. Yes, sir.
Yeah, true.
Right. If you will do this one, then the nobody can cheat on the relationship, and the relationship will also well maintain.
Yeah. And in fact, many times, you know, I will be generous enough to give some certain things which the other person is feeling to be too important, and I see that it is not so important.
Exactly.
So if the child is asking for some sweet or something, and I can see that it is not good for his health, okay, but because he is feeling so, you know, so attached to it, I might even decide to give. I say, okay, take it, you know.
Yes.
But then I know that this is not good for him, or it is not good for relationship, so I will work on him, you know, for some improvement. But till then, what do I do? Till then, I might decide that, okay, take this sweet and eat, you know.
Yes.
But then that clarity has to come that I myself have the feeling of relationship, and he also wants to have this feeling of relationship in him. But because of lack of competence, he is getting into problems. Right. I want to nurture my body. This other person also, this child also wants to nurture his body, but he doesn't know how to nurture the body. You know, those details are not known to him. So I have to, it is my responsibility to help him understand all this.
Yes. Another one, sir, nowadays also, as a teacher, we are facing, and we can also observe that. Some students, they are telling lie to their parents. They are hiding certain things with their parents, and they are spending some more amount of money as not required, right? They are for their personal, you can say that investment, right, here and there. And also, parents are blaming later on that, sir, this my son is cheating me. But I am thinking that here the proper evaluation, proper monitoring, proper understanding through the relationship with the child, right? The parents are not keeping. I'm thinking so, right? Some parents ask me, sir, why this is happening. I told, sir, this is the gap between you and your child, right? Or your son. So for this reason, this is happening. So why not your daily or some weekly, you are coming to the organization, you why not you meet with the your concerned person, concerned teacher, and take the total, you can say that activities and academic as well as discuss with the child like that. So that I'm thinking that is it coming, the gap is due to the gap between the parents and the child, sir?
There is a problem between the parents and the children. There is parents with a problem with the teachers and the students, because there is so much of gap even with the teachers and the students. All that we have to resolve. Okay. Thank you very much. I'll